Tonight's pregame brought to you by Meijer. At Meijer, you get more of the things you want, and more importantly, you get them for less. Brady Beaton up here alongside Ben Zalagi for a two-game set, but against two different teams, but two pretty darn good teams. We welcome in the Columbus River Dragons tonight, the Binghamton Black Bears tomorrow, and Ben, there's a lot to play for these next two nights. First and foremost, home ice advantage in the first round of the Commissioner Cup playoffs.
Yeah, that's what it's coming down to. Everything in the Empire is pretty much worked its way out except for the last seed. Of course, Elmira and Watertown still battling to see who's going to be that number four team. But, yeah, for right now, it's a very slim half-game lead above Danbury. Danbury's road the last five games is pretty tough, but you know what? You take care of business, you don't have to worry about Danbury.
Well, Danbury does control their own destiny. If they get every point remaining and the Rockers get every point remaining, they would finish 1 point ahead, but still a lot of runway to go. It starts tonight where Motor City tries to get back at a Columbus team that, well, was responsible for a no-good, very bad weekend a week ago. Went down to Columbus, came back 0-3, no points in hand. Sunday they battled. First 2 days weren't as good, but the Rockers get them back on home ice again tonight.
Yeah, I mean, last weekend it was a humbling experience, but again, every time we go down there, the game doesn't follow the team, right? They always kind of look off kilter. You can say it's the 16-hour bus ride. You can say, you know, it's maybe they don't have some guys that they normally have. You can throw out whatever you want. At the end of the day, they didn't come away with a win. I like the fight they showed on Sunday. Saturday was a little encouraging. You had Ricky and their other goaltender, Hunter Vasurek, who played at Liberty. He's their college signee. They had a good little battle going back and forth on Saturday, but that Friday game, it was a lot like that game last night against Port Huron. Constricting, aggressive, just taking the opportunities when you get them, because it's like Novocaine. It just takes time. And that's what Columbus did both to the Prowlers and Rockers, you know, in their last couple of games. It's impressive to see what they do. Coach Bouchard has the guys playing at an elite level like he has all year.
And Columbus on a seven-game winning streak. Still have things to play for tonight. A regulation win for the River Dragons mean they officially lock up the Continental Division and home ice to the Commissioner Cup Finals. Still a little bit away from locking up the number one overall seed, but the River Dragons looking to celebrate a division championship here in Big Boy Arena.
Yeah, well, you know what? The last time they were here at Big Boy Arena, they were on a little bit of a hot streak. Mm-hmm. We ended that as well. They're one of the hottest teams in the league. Guess what? We know how to beat them. We have done it here. Again, tip the cap to everything. Tip the cap to a guy named Justin McDonald. 38 straight games with a point. Would love to see that streak fall tonight as well. Just saying, there's hope. It's not all doom and gloom. We're going to find out if the guys have it in them tonight.
Justin McDonald, video game numbers this year. Yeah. 39 goals, 68 assists. If Justin McDonald had not scored a goal this year, he'd still be the leading point getter for the Columbus River Dragons. 107 points on the year. He is, well, he's been a human cheat code for Columbus. Motor City trying to slow them down. Seventh and final meeting between these two teams in the regular season. Rockers just 1-5, but it would leave a better taste in the mouth if you got a win to finish out this series. And what for us, we hope, could be a sign of things to come in a potential Commissioner Cup final.
Yeah, this is one of those games that can springboard your confidence. I know the guys between Saturday and Sunday down in Columbus had a little heart-to-heart saying, guys, we don't have a lot of time left. Let's make every game count. We're going to see if they're going to make it count tonight. Again, saw on Sunday a very good game. Columbus got a big goal under a minute to play on Sunday. Let's see what happens tonight. Let's see if the guys, you know, remember what happened last weekend, play like they did on Sunday, and come away with a win.
Both sides getting ready to take the ice. We will turn it over to Johnny G, our public address announcer, as we get ready for puck drop between the Motor City Rockers and the visiting Columbus River Dragons here on the Rockers Media Network. If you're looking to change your insurance coverage, Ronald Schocker is your local Farm Bureau insurance agent located in Shelby Township off of Van Dyke. He and his team have been protecting and providing Michigan families with auto, home, life, and health insurance since 2016. For all your insurance needs, trust Michigan Farm Bureau agent Ronald Schocker and request a quote today. Let's send it over to Ben to introduce the starting lineups for tonight's final regular season matchup between the Columbus River Dragons and your Motor City Rockers.
Yeah, let's start with the River Dragons, shall we? In net tonight, the young man from Wynnewood, Pennsylvania, Brendan Colgan, the two men in front of him from Littleton, Colorado, number 11, Kirk Underwood, and number 18, Nathan Balkwill from Orillia, Ontario, Canada. The men in front need no introduction, number 88, Ryan Hunter from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, number 15, Kyle Moore from Charlotte, North Carolina, and the aforementioned create a player that the River Dragons have, number 7, Justin McDonald from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. Motor City will counter with, of course, the former River Dragon, number 9, Lane King from Wananake, Wisconsin, number 17, G.J. Sneath from Chino, California, and Declan Conway from Painesville, Ohio. The defensive pairing tonight will be number 6, Jameson Milam from Lake Orion, Michigan, and Nick Miguel Diaz from Clawson, Michigan. And, of course, our player that needs no introduction, manning Gotham City in the 4x6. He is from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, number 72, Trevor Babin.
River Dragons in their road white uniforms, black pants. Rockers donning their all black uniforms here at home. River Dragons going left to right. Rockers right to left. Puck is dropped, and we are underway. The fourth straight meeting for the Rockers against the River Dragons tonight. And off the draw, sent in deep. Nick Miguel Diaz picks it up in his own zone, turns it over. Shot sticked away by Babin. Racing to the far side, Conway kicks it off the half wall, trying to get it out of the zone, cannot. Sent in deep, Miguel Diaz surveys the scene, slides it along the near wall, over the blue line, but right to a River Dragon stick, that's Balkwill. D to D pass to Kirk Underwood. Battling for it in neutral ice, goes back to Balkwill, short feed to McDonald. Races over the line, but he was a little too late, offsides the call, 35 seconds into the game. And Ben, I think a big theme in this game is going to be, how do the first 10 or 15 minutes go? Because there have been games where the Rockers come out flat, they dig themselves a hole, and then the last 45 minutes or so they play with the River Dragons, but they dug themselves in such a deep hole against a team like this, you just can't get yourself out of it.
Well, no, and we saw that last weekend, a couple of deflections in front on Friday, changed the whole tone of the game. Same thing with, obviously, on Sunday. You know, you gave up the lead, and it's just how the River Dragons play. They play aggressive. They like to dictate how the game goes. And, you know, when you're the best team in the Fed, you like to keep that moniker, but they play the lines very tight. They keep you to the outside. You just got to weather the storm a little bit and get that first one. You get that confidence, and everything will start coming.
It also helps. They just got dudes up and down their lineup. There's no denying the talent in the white and black tonight. Anderson at neutral ice. Pass across the ice. Chipped to Jemayev. Bodies being thrown around early. Dumped back in deep once again. Colton behind his own net. Waits for the change to complete. Svintsov, Delaney come off the bench. To the near side, Campbell, one of the newest Rockers, one of the three Indiana Tech signees added to this roster, dumped in deep. Talk about getting thrown to the fire. First game with the Rockers, how about the best team in the Fed?
Well, you got to learn how to play professional hockey at some point. Why not see what the best looks like?
Well, and if you play well tonight, you know you got yourselves a keeper. We've loved what Avery Smith has done early on with his time from the Rockers, one of Campbell's teammates at Indiana Tech.
Yeah, and Avery last weekend got a goal, was shorted an assist, but he did get a goal to help really spur the guys late in that not giving up rush on a Friday. So, yeah, what they had going in Indiana Tech's very impressive. They unfortunately in Nationals didn't play to their ability, but they were a top 25 team in the ACHA for a reason.
River Dragons dump in deep. Bersani chases after it, but it's picked up by the Rockers. Devon Fields fakes the give to King, has it behind the net. He was pressured to the near side. Milam up the feed, Sneath to the center of the ice. Milam can't handle it, and it's poked back between the blue lines. Miguel Diaz picks it up in stride, throws on net, easily sticked aside by Colden to the near corner. Centering pass deflected by Balkwill. Still in the River Dragons zone for the moment. Conway had to go back to neutral ice to retrieve it. Rink-wide feed to to Milam. It eventually goes up into the zone. Popped up behind the ice, behind the net rather. Centering feed, shot and saved by Colgan. Had a great opportunity early, but just over 3 minutes into the game, Brendan Colgan shows why he's one of the league's best, keeps it at zeros.
Yeah, you had him dead to rights. TJ Sneath walked in. Colgan went to his back, but kicked those legs up at the right time. That's why he's one of the best in the league, just putting on a clinic, making the most acrobatic look pedestrian.
So Brendan Colgan is a heck of a goalie. It doesn't hurt that he has a pretty nice defense in front of him. And it doesn't hurt the defense that they have one of the best goalies in the league behind them. You put that together, it's a winning formula. There's a reason why the River Dragons, just four losses in regulation this year.
Yeah, again, it speaks to the team they have, the culture that they have as well. Again, Boomer doing a very good job. Coach Bouchard doing an excellent job manning the guys, keeping them really, really well-oiled machine. It's cute. You know, we're Hockey Town, but they're playing so well they think they're Hockey Town, and they have that co-adopted moniker for a reason. They play well. They play the game the right way. You have to respect it.
Petrantonio leaked out. The Rockers got back in time. Shot was lifted up into the netting. Get an offensive zone draw for the River Dragons. 16:26 to go, first period. Scoreless here at Big Boy Arena between the Rockers and the River Dragons.
But, Brady, you know, you said, you know, weather the storm, right? So far, we're 4.5 minutes in. Motor City's doing just that. Columbus has had a couple of good opportunities. Motor City had one right there, you know, within 10 feet. So far, the ice looks pretty even. It's not really tilting either way so far. So first half of the first 10 minutes looked pretty good.
And I think part of the reason why last weekend was a bit frustrating was because you knew the Rockers had it in them. Vanderweel into the offensive zone, backhand, and Giuliano tried to stick it in. Check behind the net, and Vanderweel goes down. River Dragons trying to get it out of the zone. Field steps up to lays a hit. Svinsov pokes it back in the zone, and, well, the fans getting into it here a little early.
Well, again, you know, if you want to get physical, Motor City has no problem laying down a shoulder, so you're not going to get anyone off their game doing that. If anything, a team that will get off their game if you're physical with them will be Columbus.
In their own zone, Cody Wickline feeds the center ice, but Vanderweel stepped in front of it, kept in by Hugh Anderson. Sent to the Rocker zone, but picked up by the black and purple. Drop pass back to Vanderweel to the right side. Working into the offensive zone, feed. Sneath tries to get it on the stick. Shot out in front, it sits in the crease, but it's picked up by the River Dragons. Taking it up and out of the zone, Kyle Moore along the benches. Rink-wide feed picked off by Conway. He'll take the conservative route, slides to Vanderweel. Long shift for the captain. He's been out there for a minute.
Yeah, he has, but I don't think he wants to get off the ice. He's a guy who leads by example. Danny really will do anything and everything you ask him to and more.
5 minutes into this one, still scoreless between Columbus and Motor City. Back and forth action here at Big Boy Arena. Lane King chips it off the boards into the River Dragon zone, try to work up and out. Rockers get it right back. Pass to no one in particular, taken away by Slahetka. Into the River the Rockers zone. Dumped in deep. Milam fans on a pass. Able to battle in the corner, get it over to Koash. Bounces back in deep behind the net. To Layton, shot covered up. 4:28 to go in the first period. We get a quick break. Let's take a look at the shots on goal early. And I know there's been a couple other games that have dropped the puck in the Fed. Ben?
Yeah, well, so far shots on goal dead even at 2 a piece between Columbus and Motor City. Obviously scoreless here at Big Boy Arena, and it's like that around the league. Binghamton out at McMoran Place. Of course, Columbus will go back to McMoran Place tomorrow, finish up that series. Of course, we get the Black Bears at home tomorrow, but then you have Watertown and Danbury. They've dropped the puck. And then Blue Ridge and Carolina, they have dropped the puck as well. We're still waiting, though, for Mississippi and the Zydeco to get their concert started.
And I want to go back to a point I was talking about earlier, but we had such up and down action, couldn't delve into it. Part of the reason why last weekend was a bit frustrating is because you know the Rockers have it in them. You've seen it. Sometimes it's for a game on a weekend. Sometimes it's for a period. But if the Rockers were just an okay team, a bad team, and they went down to Columbus and went 0-3, you go, we're just a bad team. Can't compete with them. we've seen this team compete and be one of the four losses Columbus has picked up in regulation. So when you know you have it in them, they've set the bar high with their play. Just hoping the Rockers can live up to it a little more often against the top teams in the league.
Well, but here's the thing. I mean, the Rockers are, we've talked about it before in this season, Brady. You know, you have the upper echelon. That's that's right now Binghamton and Columbus. Right,
I think Carolina would argue they're in that fold, too. At least points-wise, they're in the triple digits.
I mean, they are. But I would say, but see, I would put Carolina just underneath, but at the top, like, right, like wanting to get there in the elite of the elite, right? But we know that Motor City is still a top four team, top five team in this league. We've seen it. It's just sometimes, as you said, a consistency thing. But the guys work hard. They get themselves in good positioning all the time. Not all the time, but most of the time. It's just making sure that you're doing the little things all the time. And I'm going to bring this up because I was driving in, listened to the backstage pass. Parker Brown had a really good comment. He was at practice. Obviously, he's always around getting stuff for social media, right? He was talking with Gordy on Nick Miguel Diaz's goal down in Columbus last weekend, saying, that's a drill that we run. Mm-hmm. You know, it came off a drill that we run. It was just so – it just made Gordy so happy, because when you see it like that and the game starts slowing down for you, you realize that he's been preparing you for this moment. You just got to see it, and when you do see it, it's enlightening. So, again, the guys – do play well. They just got to keep finding those moments and just string them a little bit closer together.
Just over 6 minutes into this one, still scoreless between Columbus and Motor City. In the Rocker zone, Giuliano behind his own net. Feed up to Delaney, gets it on the stick, finds Colton into the neutral zone. Bank pass over the blue line, chipped in deep. Shinkarik chases after it, puts on the brakes behind Colgan. Pressured by Svintsov, knocks the puck loose, still able to get it to the far side to Parker Layton. Finds Pietrantonio. Can't bank it off the glass and out of the zone. Columbus still looking for the breakout. Slahetka takes it over all three lines. Down the left side. Shot into the stomach of Babin. Not able to hold on to it, but it's sent to neutral ice. River Dragons have to touch up.
Well, like what Slahetka did there for Columbus, it allowed them to get the line change. He's a guy who has speed in his blades, can go all the way through and carry the puck on in. Smart play by the young man.
Wick line, hands off to Strojahan. It's knocked away, back to Strojahan. Bottom of the right wing circle, centering feed is off the mark. It'll go all the way down the ice, and Colgan has to come out of the crease to play it. 12:47 to go, first period. No score either side. It's been a clean sheet for both sides. Top of the left wing circle, pass broken up by Fields. Coming to pick it up is Delaney, and it's, excuse me, that was Sneath, and it's flipped up and out of the zone. Near their own blue line, Strojahan gives to Underwood. Over the Rocker logo at center ice. Had it poked away by Avery Smith. He's able to backhand it in deep. Babin plays it. Hands to the captain, Vanderweel. Bank pass behind the net for Devon Fields. Skates it out of his own zone. Over the red line. Why not the other blue? Fields lost the handle on it. Right wing circle. Gullo. Shot, and it goes wide. And then that Avery Smith had a look on it. Couldn't put it on net.
Well, I like the spacing there. Just didn't work out.
Koash with some hand-eye coordination to knock that puck out of the air about shin high. McDonald picks it up for the River Dragons to the far boards. Ends up on the stick of Kyle Moore. Skates it into the left wing circle. Poked behind the net. It's left. Vanderweel battling for it. Slides out in front of the net, but a Rocker picks it up to the right side. Racing and a long shot controlled by Colgan. He will play it through some danger. Koash shot doesn't make it. To Colgan. That was a dangerous play from Colgan, but no harm, no foul for the Columbus netminder.
Yeah, well, again, it's a play you don't like to see a goaltender make, but obviously it works out, so it becomes a good play. But that's a mistake by Colgan. He knew he could have held onto the puck, stopped the attack, and instead caused a giveaway. Motor City couldn't take advantage of it. But if you're going to get Colgan making mistakes like that, I like the odds in your favor.
Puck sliding over all three lines into the Rockers' zone. The veteran Jameson Milam picks it up. Feed up to Delaney on the backhand. Chipped it over. Sent in deep by back behind the net. To the near boards. Miguel Diaz sends it back in deep once again. Giuliano. Wraparound attempt broken up before it could ever get to Colgan. Milam comes down to play the puck. Jemeyev to the far side. Giuliano getting in everyone's face right now. Shot out in front. Backhand scores! Pavel Svintsov, the centering feed to the backhand, and the Rockers on top 1-0.
Beautiful look there. Beautiful opportunity for Motor City. Again, allowing guys to get into the slot. Pavel Svintsov was right there waiting for the pass. Did the extra move to make Colgan commit. Fired and shoveled the backhand. It's a 1-0 game. You love to see it.
And the hands of Pavel Svintsov being shown off, how he takes it to the backhand. There's some talented guys on the Rockers roster and across the league. The list of guys that can make that quick move and keep it on the tape is not very long. Pavel Svintsov, number 9 on the year, and the Rockers have the 1-0 lead early. And Ben, we talked about it, a quick start. That's what the Rockers get tonight.
Well, again, you need that first one. But it's a big one. And again, you had the opportunity with Sneath, right? But if all you need is one. If you can protect a little bit of a lead, as you said, survive the first 10 minutes, you got the goal within the first 10 minutes, you're looking good.
In the Rocker zone, puck slips across. King runs into his own man, Campbell. Off the back wall, chasing after it, Cody Wickline. Back to the point. Shot through traffic, doesn't make it to Babin. To the near boards, Campbell battling along the half wall. Puck still sitting on the wall as it's sent all the way back to the Columbus blue line, Parker Layton. Long feed sticks to the tape of Wickline into the offensive zone. He stick handles himself into submission, gets chipped to Strojahan, wraparound attempt goes wide. Shot paddled away by Trevor Babin. River Dragons maybe woke up a little bit as they're buzzing a little more after that goal.
Yeah, well, again, they took Sunday personally. They took Saturday personally, too. We talked about it in the pregame. They had a players come together meeting saying, hey, guys, we don't have a lot of games left. We have 4 left before it's literally do or die. What do you want to make of it? Do you want to get ready for the playoffs? Do you just want to coast into the playoffs? Because you have to have that heart-to-heart right sometimes in the locker room. You have to get the pulse right. You have to do a check. And I really appreciate that Danny Vanderweel kind of led that talk. Because he's the captain. He's literally the heart and soul of this team. And it got that blood pumping again and that competitive fire going too.
Gullo chasing it in deep. 8:49 to go first period. Pavel Svintsov has made it 1-0 Motor City. Rockers break up the pass. Underwood throwing the body around. Gullo went down to the ice and the puck went to the stick of Kyle Moore. Horseshoes it all the way around. Justin McDonald picked it up. Chipped in deep. Ryan Hunter chases after it. Back to McDonald. Shot gets deflected wide. Moore picks it up. Backhands to the right wing circle, but it was a Rocker, not a River Dragon there to knock it away. Left side of the point. Gullo drops down to an E, blocks a shot, and the bench appreciates that for Motor City. Gullo forces the turnover. It couldn't get it to the stick of Koash. That's where he was going with it.
Yeah, but it's a block like that that's playoff hockey, right? It's getting in front of a shot. It's doing the little things. And Gullo, again, not the biggest guy on the ice, but he has a heart. Right, he has a heart and a competitive fire. If you want to win games, if you want a cup run, you have to do small things like that on a constant basis.
Brody Duncan rims it around the boards, picked up by McDonald behind the net on the backhand pass, broken up, banked off the glass to neutral ice. The River Dragons will have to touch up. At least a couple of Rockers will be able to head to the bench. Rink wide feed, it's knocked away by Conway, back to King. Slow pass gets to Miguel Diaz. That's a dangerous one. But the Rockers will not pay for it. 7:30 to go, first period, 1-0 Motor City. We've gone a long time without a whistle. Columbus has been controlling the pace of play since the goal. Shinkarik to the near side. Anderson shot, and it's deflected away by Babin. Rebound poked out of the harm's way. Coming in to knock that away, TJ Sneath. They were setting up for a juicy rebound.
Yes, they were, but that's the second time Sneath has done a stick lift from behind in this period in as many shifts to correct a mistake. Like the effort there from one of the best players on the ice in TJ Sneath.
Shinkarik races over the blue line, bottom of the right wing circle, looking for a partner to pass to. Gets it to Layton on the blue line, takes it to the near wall. Puck slides down into the corner. Jemayev pokes it back, Layton stick handles, walks it between the circles, swifts on a shot, strike one to Layton, chases it down in the far corner. Back behind the net, Rockers looking for the breakout, Svintsov, one touch pass to the far side. Vanderweel with speed over the red line, backhands it in, and Colgan will trap it against the stick, and with 6:28 to go in the first period, finally get a break and a chance to check the shots and the out-of-town scoreboard. Ben, the honors are all yours.
Well, Columbus leading shots on goal 6-3. Motor City leading on the scoreboard 1-0 thanks to Pavel Svintsov goal at the 9:24 mark, assisted by Jonathan Giuliano and TJ Delaney. There is only one score change around the Fed, and it helps us a little bit, but not by much. Port Huron has a 1-0 lead against Binghamton. Still scoreless between Watertown and Danbury. Still scoreless between Blue Ridge and Carolina. And still waiting for that concert to start with the Zydeco and Mississippi.
Well, Binghamton has officially wrapped up the Empire Division.
They have.
We are locked into a series with Danbury. The only question is, who gets the one home game, who gets the two? As we mentioned in the pregame, Danbury controls their own destiny, but it's by the slimmest of margins. They would have to be perfect to clinch out if the Rockers get all points in front of them. So you got to take care of your business here first before you can look out to Danbury and hope the Wolves give you a little bit of a break.
Well, but also you got to look at it at, you know, with a glass half full approach. You still have half the point, but you're right. You know, if you get all the points you can, the Rabbits do jump you. But again, the Rabbits are facing Elmira and Watertown, two teams that are literally fighting tooth and nail for that last spot.
We know Watertown plays really well right now.
They're playing hot. I don't know what happened, but ever since they came here to Big Boy Arena, they've been playing exceptionally well.
Yeah, game one here, not so good.
No.
Game two, really good, and they followed that up with an 11-goal barrage about 40 miles north of here in Port Huron that Sunday.
Well, again, but they're playing very good hockey. Elmira, they're Jekyll and Hyde, but again, they also want to be in the playoffs. They were in the playoffs last year under new ownership. They are doing better this year. They would like to keep that trend to continue. And again, you still have three games against your rival in Binghamton, who does not like you and who doesn't want to do you any favors either. The only thing that Danbury does have, three of their last five are at home.
5:52, they'll go in the first period here at Big Boy Arena. Pavel Svintsov, the lone goal scorer, TJ Delaney, top of the right wing circle, shot goes wide of the net, hits off the glass to the Columbus blue line. It's chipped back. Danny Vanderweel picks it up for Motor City to the far side field. Sends it to Gullo. He'll touch it as it goes all the way down behind the net. Colgan plays it, hands off to Balkwill. To the far side, kept in up to the right wing circle. Centering feed, shot, and it's knocked up into the netting. Another chance between the circles for Motor City. Ben, that's the third opportunity from that spot so far this period. A bit of an abnormal amount for this River Dragon defense.
Yeah, it is. They like to keep you to the outside. The fact Motor City's been able to get in between the hashes three times and convert on that. So you're one out of three in hockey ain't bad by any stretch of the imagination. Like the play, though, of Nathan Balkwill to get a stick on it, because if not, Koash probably scores, and it's a whole new game at that point.
Underwood, stretch pass, gets through, but not to the stick of Hunter. Rockers controlled in their own zone. Campbell gave it to the near side, flipped up, almost kisses the rafters. Campbell chases after it, leaves it. Shot on net from Smith is easily sticked aside by Colgan. Rockers still control it, rink-wide feed. Colton off the bank, and it's deflected before it gets to Colgan. River Dragons looking for the breakout. They get it up to Moore, right wing circle, and it's broken up. Heck of a job by Josh Colton to neutralize the opportunity. 4:43 to go, first period, 1-0, Rockers on top. Colton rings around to the far side. McDonald lets it hop over his stick. Return feed behind him. Colton picks it up behind his own end line. Hunter pressures. Get it to the near wall. Racing up the near side. King into the offensive zone. Puts on the brakes. Pressured on the boards. Slides back between the blue lines. To the far side, Milam into the offensive zone. Flips in deep. Colgan comes way out of the crease to play it. Milam throws on net. Don't think that was intended as a shot. Got to the middle. Duncan sends it up into the neutral zone. Pitcher Antonio races after it. Miguel Diaz shadows him. Pokes it away. Rockers looking for the breakout. Rink-wide feed. Hits the stick of Svintsov. Gets it into the offensive zone. He's knocked off the puck. Back between the blue lines. These two teams going back and forth, throwing bodies around.
Well, again, if you want to get physical, that's not out of the realm of Motor City's game at all. It doesn't get you off kilter, doesn't get you off schedule. In fact, I know a handful of guys on Motor City welcome it.
Conway off the back wall.
He is one of them.
Gets chipped into the neutral zone. Miguel Diaz Skating backwards up to Giuliano to the far side. Diagonal dump in. Svinsov chases after it. He battles with Anderson. To the near side, Svinsov in the corner, working against two River Dragons. Slides off a stick. Brody Duncan picks it up. Rings it off the boards and chasing after it, Danny Vanderweel. 3:07 to go first period. Rockers have been controlling the pace of play the last couple minutes. Vanderweel, offensive zone to Delaney, returns to the captain. Back behind the net, forced off the puck, coming in to help Alex Strojahan as the River Dragons work for a breakout. Parker Layton on the near side, over the red line, to the blue. Stops at the top of the right wing circle. Knocked away on the near boards. Giuliano for Motor City, dumps it in diagonally. Delaney looks a bit gassed at the end of his shift, was chasing after it, but Slaheka won it. Strojahan on the rush for Columbus. Whiffs on a pass, gets it back to the blade of a stick. Centering feed, doesn't find a home. Koash picks it off. He's working down the right side of the ice. Avery Smith joins him. Koash, top of the right wing circle, shot, and it's punched away by Colgan. Rings all the way back out to neutral ice. Colton to the far side to Devon Fields. Surveys the scene. Can't get the pass off. The pressure from Bersani forced him to, well, get nothing on that pass.
Yeah, no, instead it leads to a wall battle.
2 minutes to go, first period. The only one who scored, Pavel Svinsov of Motor City. King takes the feed in front of his own bench. Back into his own zone for Josh Colton. He waits for the Rockers to complete a line change. Smith and Wickline had a few words for each other as they went to their respective benches. King lost it on the stick handle going into the offensive zone. Turnover gives it to the River Dragons. Ryan Hunter shot from a shallow angle and it's shouldered away by Babbitt. Along the near wall, 90 seconds to go, first period. Rockers nursing a 1-0 lead. Diagonal dumping. This period's had a lot of flow, not many whistles in the first 20 minutes. We're flying through the opening period, and right on cue, Trevor Babin watches one go into the trapper. 1:16 left to go in the first. That's our first whistle under 5 minutes. So one final check on shots on goal, and, well, scores from around the Fed in this period.
Well, still getting doubled up. Columbus leading Motor City 8-4 in the shots category. But again, Motor City leading where it matters. Pavel Svinsov getting his first goal since March 2nd, giving Motor City a 1-0 lead. Outside of that, Port Huron still has their 1-0 lead over Binghamton. Danbury and Watertown still scoreless. Blue Ridge and Carolina also still scoreless. And not to sound like a broken record, but, or maybe a broken washboard, because the Zydeco and Seawolves, or the Voodoo Generals, whichever you prefer, have not dropped the puck yet.
1:16 left to go in the opening period here at Big Boy Arena. Fans, Iconic Goaltending has clinics here in Metro Detroit. You're a young goaltender looking to improve your game, or information on private lessons, team skates, performance analysis, and more can be found at iconicgoaltending.com. 1:16 left to go in this opening period. And
well, really quick, Vincent DeCumbis was the goal scorer shorthanded to give Port Huron the 1-0 lead against Binghamton.
Well, it's not a shocker that Port Huron scored down a man. That is not uncommon for the Prowlers.
Well, and then also Danbury just scored. Daniel McKintrick at the 11:30 mark gives the Wabbits a 1-0 lead.
Motor City with the 1-0 lead. Columbus trying to tie it before we head to the locker room for the first break. They win the offensive zone draw. Balkwell gets it in. Moore shot misses the net. Hits off the back glass. Delaney tried to slide it to a teammate. McDonald stepped in front of it just inside his own zone. Backhands it around the boards. Giuliano the first to get there. Far corner. Bank pass. Gets to Underwood. Spins around. Ends up in the bottom of the left wing circle. Shot out in front and Babin there to deny the league's leading scorer, Justin McDonald. Still 1-0 Rockers.
Well, we said Motor City has been in between the hashes three times. Columbus was in between the hashes twice on a single offensive possession under a minute to go. Don't like seeing that. Loving that Trevor Babin's cleaning up mistakes. But keep the guys away from Broadway, right? Right down Woodward.
Especially number seven.
Yeah, dear Lord, the creative player, right?
Basically anyone besides him. Shot doesn't make it to Babin. Rockers looking for a rush here in the final minute. Racing down the far side. All he can do is dump it in as Avery Smith was running out of real estate. River Dragons chip it across all three lines into the Rockers zone. Nick Miguel Diaz skating backwards near his end line. Gets it back between the blue lines. River Dragons can't get it into the offensive zone. They have to reset. Petri Antonio chips it in deep. 17 seconds to go in the first. On the near side, Motor City. Feed up to Coash. Shot gets lifted up into the netting, and 5.9 on the scoreboard before the end of the first 20 minutes. Rockers will get one last shot in the offensive zone.
Well, shooters shoot, right? I would have preferred Scott just to hold on to it, take it to the end of the period. But shooters shoot. You're going to try to get as many shots as you can on a goaltender because one could go in, right? So don't fault him for it, but would not like to see a face-off here. Just would have liked a nice little walk down into the locker room and live to fight another day.
Sneath will take the draw for Motor City against McDonald. Have 6 seconds. Don't have to shoot right off the draw should you win it. Sneath chases after it. Colgan chips it to the corner. Pass taken away. Up top, the shot gets deflected before it makes it to Colgan. And after 20 minutes of play, the Motor City Rockers lead Columbus 1-0 thanks to Pavel Svinsov. Then let's take one final look at the shots on goal and recap the one and only goal of the period.
Well, it's now 10-4 in favor of Columbus over Motor City in the shots department. But as we said, we have the lead where it matters on the scoreboard. The 9:24 mark of the first period, Jonathan Giuliano won a puck battle at the end line, fed it in front. Pavel Svinsov caught the pass in between the hashes, deked to his backhand, and shoveled the puck in for number 9 on the year. And that's how we got to 1-0 after 20.
Thought the Rockers played a pretty strong first 20 minutes. We talked about it in the pregame. The name of the game is always going to be consistency. But if they can play like they did in that first 20, if they can bottle it up and get it most periods, they're going to be a tough team to beat, whether it's the rest of the regular season or come playoff time.
Well, and yeah, and that's why, I do appreciate the little heart-to-heart these guys had in Columbus, right? We knew what the litmus test was going to be. We've talked about it before. This is the litmus test, right? This is what it is. You had three tough games in Columbus. Now you have two tough games at home. And if you come out with a split or better here at home, my goodness is the pressure on Danbury. So again, it's what do you want to make of this last run? You're in the playoffs. Do you want to be home? Do you want to go to Danbury? That's really the question, because if you do that and figure that out, you're going to set yourself up for a cup run, Brady. You really are, because you're going to be playing with confidence. You know you can hang with the best in the league, which you're going to have to get through if you want to hoist a trophy at the end of the season.
Last Impressions Promotional Marketing is the official merchandise provider of the Motor City Rockers. This family-owned Michigan business is conveniently located in Canton. Looking for corporate branding with excellent value at an economical price? Check out Lasting Impressions at LITEAM.com. That's LITEAM.com, a proud partner of your Motor City Rockers. Through 20 minutes, the Rockers lead it 1-0. We'll step aside. We'll come back right before the start of the second period here on the Rockers Media Network.
Just over. Last chance.
Hey, fans, if you want free tickets to every Rockers home game next season, please visit the merch store next time you come to Big Boy Arena for your chance to be a part of the band and win 2024-25 Motor City Rockers season tickets. The winner will be revealed at the season finale on April 13th. Please visit the merch store above Section 7 to enter. And, well, that means the playoffs are almost here, and you can guarantee yourself a seat to every Rockers home playoff game by purchasing the Hat Trick Plan. Please contact the Rockers front office for further questions and to purchase your tickets. Brady Beaton alongside Ben Zalagi. And after 20 minutes of play, the Rockers thought to put together a pretty strong first period. They lead it 1-0 thanks to Pavel Svensov. There's obviously always going to be things to correct, but the list a lot shorter than after the first periods of any of last week's games.
Yeah, no, it's a good solid 20 minutes. You know, you could argue it was a good solid 19 minutes and then an okay performance in the last minute, which is still fine. You still have the lead, though, but what you're doing, you're playing well. How are you playing well? You're playing that neutral zone pretty well. You're also breaking up passes, getting sticks in passing lanes in the defensive end. You're not seeing a lot of clean breakouts from Columbus. They have to carry the puck in deep. They're bringing a guy down low to do that, and then when they try to center it back out, again, that's where you're breaking up the passes. So, like what Motor City's adjusting to so far, but I don't like what I saw in the last minute. Again, in one offensive possession, Columbus did get two shots in the slot, including one from Justin McDonald. You can't let that happen. He's going to make you pay for it more often than not. Thank God we have the Dark Knight in between the 4x6, and he stopped it. But again, just clean up that. You know, don't get too comfortable. Get a win here. Keep playing tough. Keep playing hard. You outplayed them for a good solid portion of the first period.
Well, here the thing is, Columbus is going to get some opportunities.
Yes.
You're not going to dominate them for 60 minutes. It's surviving. Hey, sometimes it's Trevor Babin making a big save. Sometimes it's TJ Sneath lifting the stick in the low slot. You just have to be able to pick each other up because Columbus is going to get opportunities. The River Dragons aren't first in the division for no reason. They're going to do things well. It's how do you respond and can you limit those opportunities over the course of 60 minutes?
Yeah, I mean, there is that, but also, I mean, also you have to look at it this way too, right? Last weekend in the second period, that's what killed Motor City.
Mm-hmm.
They were held to their almost their three lowest shot totals of the second period all season just last weekend. So, you know, what – you got to get through that mental hurdle as well. And, yes, Columbus will get opportunities. But, again, get your sticks in. Find the opportunities to correct mistakes. As you mentioned, TJ Sneath did a couple with a good stick lift. You're seeing guys work through in between the hashes. Gullo's been protecting the slot very, very well. Koash is ready off a line change, picking up an errant pass. So guys are doing what they need to do. Yes, you know, again, Columbus will get their opportunities. You just got to limit the opportunities that they do get.
Fans, check out the Motor City Rockers social media or go to the merch stand for information on our pet appreciation warm-up jerseys. The raffle will close Sunday, March 31st at 7 p.m. Again, make sure to check out the Rockers on social media for all of that information. Of course, you may be watching on some of our Rockers social media across the Rockers Media Network, whether it be on YouTube, X, Rumble, Caffeine TV, Facebook, wherever you are watching. Thank you so much for making us a part of your Friday night. Rockers have held up their end of the bargain. They lead it 1-0 as we enter the second period of play. Rockers now going left to right. River Dragons right to left. And both sides out, just waiting for that time to run out. They're itching to go.
Yeah, both these teams have a nice, healthy respect for one another. Again, some people, like Columbus's broadcaster, Tom Callahan, will say it's a rivalry. I just think it's a healthy respect. I don't think there is a rivalry between these two teams. It's just two coaches that respect each other, players that want to prove, you know, something to one another. It's just a good, clean, healthy respect, I think.
Well, anytime you have two teams at the top of any league, there might be a natural rivalry feel when you play each other a fair bit, and it usually means something.
Sure. Sure, but I mean, anytime you play the top team in any league, you know, it's going to mean something. But I don't think there's any hate or ill will behind it, except when you use the Hockey Town moniker. Then it gets a little weird and personal.
Babin passes it out of the crease, and the puck went into the River Dragons bench. 38 seconds into the second period. We'll see who controls the play. There were times in that first where the River Dragons felt like they were in the offensive zone for 2, 3, 4 minutes at the time. Then the Rockers turned it around, and they were getting some movement in the offensive zone. Off the draw in the neutral zone.
Thought maybe they would redraw that one. Thought Shinkarik got there a little early.
Even if that may be the case, the Rockers got it into the River Dragon zone. Jemayev, backhand pass off the mark. Babin plays it, rings it off the high glass, goes past the stick of Layton, chasing after it. Avery Smith, he is bodying Slahetka, and a shot from Koash gets deflected up and out of play. Avery Smith, we talked about it last time we were here at home, but he's been a very welcome addition to the Rockers. 4 points in 5 games played, and he's got a little bit of that sandpaper to him as well.
Well, we liked what he did so well. We picked up two of his teammates. I mean, again, a tip to the cap to Indiana Tech, producing really good hockey players. But yeah, Avery Smith just stepped onto the ice. You thought he was with the team the whole way through. Again, reminds me of Tommy Cardinal a little bit, not just physically how he looks, but how he plays. And he does. Plays the game the right way, plays it tough, plays it hard. And if that's the type of guys you get out of Fort Wayne, which it is, not a bad recipe to have if you want to start looking towards the future of your roster and how you want to build it and construct it, because we have guys that are like that as well.
In neutral ice, TJ Delaney gives back to Devon Fields, slides over to Vanderweel. He assesses the situation, short feed to Delaney. Out of his own zone, past neutral ice and into the River Dragon zone. Along the near half wall, Delaney shot from a bad angle is easily knocked aside by Colgan. Delaney chases after it, gets to Giuliano. Give and go, Giuliano tried to leave it back for Fields, went to the corner. Vanderweel walks it up, shoots, scores! Danny Vanderweel, the captain, walks it between the circles, picks the corner, and the Rockers lead it 2-0 here in the second.
Like the patience, like the stalk. Just walked his way into the high slot, picked his opportunity, and buried it. Love it by the captain.
Number 7 on the year for number 19. And Ben, where did that shot come from? Right between the circles. Everyone crashed down in the corner, able to leak it back out. And Vanderweel knew he had space. And man, he put that in a soup can right in the top left corner. That's a heck of a way to come out here in the second period.
And what a pass from the end line, though. Got it through traffic. Just found Danny right at the right time. Again, allowed him to stalk. That was gorgeous.
Jamison Milam in his own zone. Banks it off the near wall. Boys are buzzing here in Big Boy Arena. Sneath. Pass gets knocked away. Conway chases after it. Banks it back to the point. Miguel Diaz barely keeps it in. Battle for it on the boards. It hops over the Rocker blue line. They knock it back to the Rocker zone. Milam. Long feed up to Conway. Backhand into the offensive zone. King puts on the brake, surveys the scene across the rink to Milam. Right wing circle and the shot deflected. They were looking to get to Sneath inside, maybe tip one in. In the Motor City zone, it's sent back out to Brody Duncan. Ringed around the boards. Nick Miguel Diaz chases after it. Leaves it for Koash. Spins around, tries to kick it to his stick. Miguel Diaz can't get it as he slashes at it. In the Rocker zone, Bersani on the half wall, chips in deep to Storjahan. To Moore in the corner, pass in front, broken up, hit off the official as it's sent all the way down. And two things we didn't have in that first period. Neither side had an icing, and neither side got called for a penalty. A pretty clean first 20 minutes. That's continued here into the second.
Yeah, so far, so good. And again, Motor City's gotten into the slot 4 times and converted at now 50%.
Scott Koash wheeling down the ice. Tries to work around Balkwell. Did a good job. Didn't do too much, just got in the way. Colton keeps it in the zone. Tipped, and it goes just wide of the net. Had Colgan going to his right. Puck was on the near side and a big hit from Gullo, and that's going to be the first penalty of the game. Here with 16:11 to go in the second period. And there were a swarm of Dragons around Gullo. Avery Smith taking exception.
I don't like what Ryan Hunter's doing either. This has been something that was brewing from last weekend. Kyle Moore was an agitator all weekend to Nick Gullo last weekend because that's who they shade up against each other. And Gullo finally got a good look on him, and the low man won. And it was, again, brewing for a good solid 7 days, and Gullo just got the best of him.
We'll go to the Insight Healthcare penalty kill. If you're not feeling yourself, visit one of Insight's locations across Southeast Michigan for all of your medical needs and get some insight to your health today. 16:11 to go, second period. Rockers lead it 2-0, but they go down a man, send the PK unit out for the first time tonight, and a chance for the River Dragons to get one back.
Well, you were just saying we had clean hockey, and then, well, you said the magic words. We don't have clean hockey anymore.
Probably some Rockers fans yelling at their TV about the announcer's jinx, but let's see what the Rockers PK can do. First time they've been tasked tonight. Draw comes to the left of Trevor Babin.
Well, the announcer's jinx like puck luck, right? You love it, you hate it, you live with it. It is what it is.
And no one remembers the time you say there wasn't a penalty and then it goes 20 minutes without a penalty.
Exactly. There's that.
Shinkarik over to the right side. Wickline shot deflected to the near side. Slahetka gives back to Shinkarik. Slides to Slahetka. Left wing circle, pass deflected, rebound scores! Didn't take long, Alexander Jemayev, and 22 seconds into the power play, River Dragons get on the board, 2-1, Rockers still on top, but Alexander Jemayev, his 29th of the year, comes on the rebound.
Well, you don't get close to 30 goals by accident. Jemayev was right there for the rebound. Where was he hiding? Low circle. Came right out for him. He had all the time in the world in a wide open net. The only thing is, when you have 30 goals, you don't get that adrenaline rush where you might miss it, right? He's like, oh, no, thanks, and then just puts it in. Jemayev gets number 29 of the year. It was right place, right time, good positioning, beautiful rebound goal.
Each side has lit the lamp once in the first 4 minutes and change here in the second period. 2-1 Motor City. Delaney wins the puck battle at center ice, banks it off the end boards. Svintsov back to the point. Shot on net, knocked down by Parker Layton. He races over all three lines to the right side. Shot gloved out of the air by Trevor Babin. Flashed in the leather, keeping it a 2-1 game.
Well, he wanted to make up for giving up that rebound, and he did just that. The Dark Knight showing why he is called the Dark Knight. Makes spectacular saves.
I love the save by Babin. I don't like that Layton was able to skate from his own zone right to the right wing circle and get a clean look on the netminder.
Well, no. I mean, no one's going to like that, but, you know, it is what it is. Again, as you said, Brady, good teams get good opportunities.
Yes,
you just got to limit the opportunities, right? That's all.
Draw in the Rockers zone. Tied up. Svintsov comes away with it. 2-on-2, he dumps it in diagonally, hits off the top of the boards, and I believe the official accidentally blew the whistle. As soon as he blew it, he started tapping his chest, I believe, indicating he thought it went out of play. So it'll be an offensive zone draw for Motor City.
Well, there's worse mistakes, right?
Yeah, I mean, it hit off the top of the glass.
And that's just it.
Maybe anticipated a little too much.
Well, we've had that.
There are worse things to get wrong as an official.
I was going to say, we've had in this league across many different games, so not singling out anyone, but some things that have been called something that have happened that has not happened. So, again, if that's the worst that comes out of it, then that's okay. You just have a reset.
Svintsov gives it low, give and go, and it hops over the stick of Svintsov. Miguel Diaz, shot, scores! Nick Miguel Diaz gets it right back for the Rockers. 3-1 Motor City.
Well, that was pretty. I'm not going to say anything else. That was pretty. That was just pretty. Nick got one last weekend, got one this weekend, got a big one back. He gave up a power play goal. They cut it back within one, and guess what? The lead grows back to two. The comeback is not on.
I love the response by Motor City. They win a puck battle. It started on the near wall. They win the puck battle, gets it in deep, Didn't matter that it hopped over the stick of Svinsov. Nick Miguel Diaz picked it up and picks the corner for his eighth of the year. And Ben, if the Rockers are going to be picking corners like they are tonight, they're going to be celebrating a lot, and that lamp's going to be going off often the rest of the year.
Well, maybe we've got to have just more team chats. I mean, I don't know what.
Or get shots between the circles a little more often. Back on the offensive rush, Gullo shoveled it in. It was sticked aside by Colgan. Back to Smith, walks it in. Trio of Dragons come to knock him off the puck. Fields back to Gullo, return to Fields, kicks it to the stick, throws on net, kicked aside by Colgan. Koash battling in low, shot, and it hits. Ooh, hits the official. I think that caught him in the knee.
Yeah, he's feeling that.
Who? A little slow moving. He's shaking it off. Another shot saved by Colgan.
Yeah, Chris Rowe is going to need an ice pack.
He's moving a little slow. Don't know if he's just trying to get it, get the feeling back, but he's hunched over. Offside's the call, 14:23 to go in the second period. Ben, let's take a look at shots on goal and scores from around the league.
Well, this time Motor City leads shots on goal, 5-2, but trail in the game, 12-9. Again, just reintroduced the scoring for you. Danny Vanderweel opened the second period with a goal. Alexander Jemayev on the power play 3 minutes later. Cut it to 2-1, and then Nick Miguel Diaz, well, that was what, 40 seconds, 39 seconds apart, made it back to 3-1. Looking out around the league, Port Huron has a 2-0 lead over Binghamton. Danbury has a 1-0 lead over Watertown. Carolina has a 1-0 lead as well. And the puck just dropped at the Raisin Cane Center in Baton Rouge.
Well, for fans that don't know, this will be the last weekend both Ben and I will be in the broadcast booth together, because starting the final week of the regular season, the Motor City Rockers will have a partnership and will be on the radio. If you want to promote your business on the radio, we have partnered with Salem Media Group and Rock. You can get your business on those broadcasts. Contact the Rockers front office for information on how to be involved with this unique opportunity. I think it's another step in this organization moving forward. But from now on, all home games for the rest of this year will have two different broadcasts. I'll be on the radio. Ben will stay on the TV side. And just another way to consume Rockers hockey.
Well, and the ironic thing is I have a face for radio, so you think it'd be the other way around. You're the better looking of the two, Brady.
Well, they don't show us on the YouTube feed anyway, so I think we're both safe there.
There's a reason for that, young man. There's a reason for that.
Well, that will start. The first radio broadcast will actually be in Port Huron.
Yeah, you and I get to
have fun. We'll be up there, and then back here the next night we'll have the entirety of the playoffs. Hopefully, what is a lengthy playoff one for the Rockers. If they keep playing like they are tonight, I expect big things come postseason time. 3-1 Motor City leads Columbus. River Dragons in their own zone, whiffing on a pass. Brody Duncan able to recover, doesn't find the tape. Campbell back behind his own net, gives it right to Shinkarik. Feed broken up before it can reach the middle of the circles. Shot from the top of the right wing circle. Trevor Babin lost his stick, trying to get it to him, and he's able to freeze the puck. Pietrantonio couldn't tip it by Babin. And a much-needed whistle and a chance to reset for number 72.
Like how Campbell tried to help him out, fished him the stick right back to him. Trevor said, it's okay, man. I got it. I'm not panicking here. Just makes a good save. Again, Trevor Babin, we talk about iconic goaltending, having clinics. Trevor is a goal coach in his off time. Back in Philadelphia, he's trained kids. He's helped out, here as well. There's a reason. You can pick up really good habits from Trevor.
Off the draw, Motor City controls it. Delaney over center ice logo on the near side. Gets rubbed off the puck. Picked it up, Kirk Underwood. In neutral ice, Milam's pass. Too far for Svinsov. He chases after it. Balkwell backhands it to the far side. Kyle Moore leaves it for McDonald. Rink-wide feed to the skate of Hunter. Can't get it to the stick. Giuliano picks up the loose puck. His pass taken away by McDonald. Dumps in deep. Hunter battling for it. Finds McDonald. Shot, and it doesn't make it to Trevor Babin. Oh, another dangerous spot for number 7. But this time, Trevor Babin doesn't even get the chance to make the save. 12:56 to go, middle frame. Rockers 3, Columbus 1, a much better showing than a week ago for these Motor City Rockers here at home. Battling in their own zone, Milam chipped it up and out, racing after it. Kirk Underwood turns it over. Koash into the offensive zone. Can't put the dangle on. Backhand knocked away. Rebound kicked aside by Colgan. He didn't know where it was, but his defenders helped him out and sent it to safety.
Man, Colgan is seeing ghosts, and if he's seeing ghosts, that's a good thing.
Vanderweel with the poke check. Colgan had to come out of the crease to play it. Rockers are buzzing right now, Ben.
Well, but here's the thing, right? Colgan, again, I'm saying he's seeing ghosts. Why? He knew he had the pad save. He kicked out the leg, but then he looked behind. So that means he has a lack of confidence. That body language is very enticing. That is like, you know, when you're just in a competitive mode with somebody and you start to see him flinch just a little bit, you know you have the edge on him. If he's seeing ghosts in between his 4x6, that is a darn good sign for the rest of the game. And that is odd by Brendan Colgan. This guy is the most reliable, solid goaltender in this league that you can come across. It is very weird that he is displaying the body language he is playing tonight. Because, again, he is one of the best that we have in this league for a reason.
Colgan's given up 3 goals on 13 Rockers shots so far tonight. Svintsov, Vanderweel, and Miguel Diaz each have lit the lamp for Motor City. On the forecheck, shot from Sneath goes wide of the net, and Motor City generating more and more opportunities. They're coming more often, and at that same spot, River Dragons look a step slow. Turnover, Sneath, shot kicked aside, scramble for it. Motor City comes away with it. On the far half wall, King backhands it to Sneath. Conway tried to almost set a pick for him. Slipped to the corner. Conway gets it back. Puck battle in the dirty area, sent all the way out down the ice. No icing, so Trevor Babin will play it.
No, it was definitely touched by Motor City in the end, so wasn't going to be icing no matter what.
Slaheka kicks it to Swan. First time we've said his name tonight. Far side, Storjahan. Lost it, Sneath. Can't get it past Storjahan. Center, Swan, shot gets deflected by Fields. Did not flinch, was right in front of Sequoia Swan to knock it away.
Well, he may not have flinched, but the eyes probably closed.
Rockers wanted a penalty, not getting it. Vanderweel on the right side, backhand, and it's driven into the boards. Arm goes up. Vanderweel slow to get up, but he is up. And a little bit of a tussle.
Well, that was flashbacks back to Danbury.
That was not a nice-looking hit.
No, Hunter wanted all of them. No, I'm sorry, that's not even Hunter. I apologize.
And Brody Duncan.
That's Brody Duncan.
And he actually, ironically, may have got the worst of it.
Well, yeah, he's calling for the trainer. I think he may have possibly separated his shoulder. He is not moving that left arm at all.
He looks like he's heading to the locker room.
But that was headhunting by Duncan. That close down low, that's headhunting.
We'll see what the damage is, but the Rockers are going to go on the Genesis Credit Union Power Play. Learn how Genesis can put more money in your pocket and become one of its over 200,000 members at genesiscu.com or at any of their convenient locations near you.
If this is not I just saw the replay. If this is not a 5, I will be shocked.
Well, Kyle Moore will be the one to serve it. So Duncan going off the ice. 2 minutes go up on the clock, and the Rockers have a chance to take a 3-goal lead on their first Genesis Credit Union power play of the night.
I don't like that. I do not like that at all. The head was down into the boards. Duncan had ill intent the whole way. I would like to see 3 more on that one. That is, I don't like that. I just don't like that. Okay. I don't agree with it. I think it should be a 5. Well, it doesn't matter who did it. That's a 5.
Rockers get 2. See if they can convert as quickly as the River Dragons did on their power play. Tie up on the draw. Sent back to the point. Colton, near side King, the former River Dragon, returns to Colton. Bottom of the left wing circle. Rink-wide feed finds King on the hash marks. Return feed can't make it to Koash. That was Bersani that got the stick in front of it. Colton, bank pass to Koash, 20 seconds into the Genesis Credit Union power play. Back, Koash, shot through traffic, goes over the crossbar, up the glass. Colton picks it up. Pressure from McDonald, pass, one touch. to the near side, and McDonald was trying to leak out. Colton was with him all the way. In the offensive zone, McDonald right side, and unable to hold on to it, Hunter Bersani. 1:14 left to go in the Brody Duncan minor penalty. Have a rock, a River Dragon down in front of Trevor Babin. It's 5-on-3 for the moment.
Well, he did get hit from behind.
And now we get the whistle.
I don't know how hard that hit was, but he did get hit from behind.
So as they attend to the Down River Dragon, we'll take our media timeout. We have a minute left to go in the Genesis Credit Union power play. 9:53 left to go in the middle period. So Ben, let's take a look at shots on goal and scores from around the area.
Yeah, well, shots on goal. Motor City dominating the second period, 11-5, has now tied it up for the game, 15-15. Motor City still has a 3-1 lead here, thanks to the latest goal scored by Nick Miguel Diaz at the 4:50 mark. So it has been 5 minutes since a goal has been scored. Port Huron has a 2-0 lead at McMorrin Arena. Vincent DeCumbis and Liam Freeborn giving them the 2-0 lead against the Binghamton Black Bears. It is still a 1-0 lead just after one. Daniel McKintrick giving the Danbury Hattricks that 1-0 lead over Watertown. Then we're going to go look at the Fairgrounds Arena where Dawson Baker got the goal for Carolina at the 12:41 mark, giving them a 1-0 lead. And nothing has been resolved so far at the Raising Cane Center, but Bersani was able to get up under his own power, which is very nice to see. You don't want anyone obviously getting hurt. He did get hit hard, so good to see he's not any worse for wear.
Fans, if you love coming to Motor City Rockers game but just can't quite commit to a full season ticket package, well, we have the solution for you. Contact the Rockers front office to learn more about our flexible, personalized mini game ticket packages for the 2024-25 season. We love when you guys come out. You guys are usually some of the loudest fans. There's not a lot of room for the sound to go. So when we do get a good crowd, we've got a solid crowd here tonight. Place gets loud. Been loud 3 times tonight. Rockers lead it 3-1 over Columbus. 9:53 to go, second period. Still a minute left to go on the Brody Duncan minor penalty.
Well, I just saw the hit Declan Conway offered on Bersani. He got him. He got underneath, and I think what happened with Bersani is his head hit Babin's pad, so that's why his head kind of got tilted in the wrong direction.
Right now, Bersani and Duncan both back in the dressing room for Columbus. Off the draw, Milam kept it in the zone only for a moment. Back to neutral ice, Nick Miguel Diaz feeds to the near side, drop pass to Giuliano. To the far side, Delaney, back to the point, Milam. Clapper doesn't make it to Colgan, sent to the corner. Battle for it in the far corner. Poking, prodding, Giuliano, the one to come away with it. Slides it across the boards, able to get there in time. Nick Miguel Diaz, 30 seconds left to go on the power play. On the right wing circle, to the point, Milam surveys the scene. Left side, Delaney settles the puck down. Brings it back to the point, to the near side. Nick Miguel Diaz, he centers. One touch pass, Delaney, right wing circle, centering feed, and Milam couldn't handle it. It's cleared down, and another opportunity for Motor City. This time goes by the wayside as the clear brings it to the final 10 seconds of the Genesis Credit Union power play.
Yeah, Motor City's power play hasn't looked right in a couple of games. They dropped from first to third because of it in the league, but they had a couple of good opportunities. Just, again, bounced off the skate wrong of Milam. He was right there in the slot, though, like Motor City has been most of the game. Just got to fix the power play. Don't know what's really wrong with it.
Back to five-a-side hockey as Kyle Moore serving the penalty for Duncan came out of the box. Pass out in front, and Duncan just couldn't get enough of the stick on it. Sneath, backhand, doesn't make it to Colgan, sent all the way down the ice. Babin was going to ask for icing, realized that would be a losing proposition, comes out of the crease to play it. To the far side, it's poked by McDonald. He's able to recover it. Right wing circle. To the blue line to Slahetka. Pass across, and he tried to tip it in. Kyle Moore tied up. Nice job by the new guy, Will Campbell, to neutralize that opportunity.
Also, Babin cutting down the angle, sliding out to try to deflect it as he could.
8:02 left to go, second period. 3-1 Motor City here on a Friday night. Thank you so much for spending the start of the weekend with us. Pass goes high and wide. Conway chases after it. Spins off a hit, but loses the stick in the process. Gullo picks it up, chips off the boards, racing after it. Ooh. Works around Slahetka, still has it on the stick. That's a one-man clear, a shot that, well, didn't have much of a shot, was shouldered away by Colgan, but a heck of an effort from 94 Nick Gullo.
Well, if Nick Gullo is 5'7", he got his head taken off. He's 5'6", he's able to duck down under a hit, but man, these bodies and temperature is starting to rise.
Smith couldn't get it by Slahetka. River Dragons going the other way, pass off the mark. Say it was touched, no icing called. Fields in his own corner, poking, prodding at the puck. Slips all the way out to the point, kept in by the backhand of Underwood. Turned over, Fields, feed up to Koash. Tipped in deep, Rockers will complete the change. Balkwill, far side, rings it around behind his own netminder to Storjahan. Up to the near half wall. Another puck battle in the dirty areas. That's a spot where I think Motor City has succeeded tonight, and it shows on the scoreboard. Nick Miguel Diaz feels Storjahan behind him, tries to chip it up the near side.
Ooh, that's another big hit.
You've heard the boards crunching a few times so far tonight. And while it's been physical, only a one penalty for each side, so for the most part, been above board, with a few exceptions.
Well, yeah, but again, I think this is what carried over from Sunday, right? Sunday was a little more physical game between the two at the Civic Arena down in Columbus, Georgia. So this is just basically a carryover. And again, anytime you want to get physical with Motor City, it doesn't get them off their game. Columbus is the one that needs to respond a little bit here. They look a little bit lost, but here's the thing. They can get back into a game just with like a snap of a finger. So you got to keep the pressure on them. Everything's looking good so far, but you cannot let up.
Let's take it back to what we talked about in the pregame. Consistency, period to period and game to game. Rockers have played a pretty consistent first 34 minutes and change. Pietrantonio in his own zone. The River Dragon captain gives to Storjahan. Return feed broken up by Miguel Diaz. Smith kicks it over his own blue line. Gullo couldn't get to it in time. Sent back into the Rockers zone. Nick Miguel Diaz has it on his stick. Surveys the scene as he glides to neutral ice. Jermayev had it, lost it. Picked up by another River Dragon. This time it's Slahetka. He's knocked down from behind. Smith throwing the body around. A return hit from Jermayev. And Smith, there's the sandpaper we talk about as the icing's called. He's not afraid to throw the body out. He can dish it as well as he can take it.
Well, again, that's why he reminds me of Tommy Cardinal. Tommy Cardinal was a guy who would get mad at you for no reason. Avery needs a reason. But once he has the reason, he's like a bull that sees red. He's just going to go after you no matter what. So really like what we got in Avery so far. He's a guy that really fits this mold. But he's the modern enforcer. He's a guy who can get dirty, but also he has skill in his game, skates very, very well, makes good decisions. You gotta like what he does.
And another big body on the ice. Slahetka's shot kicked aside by Trevor Babin to the near corner. Layton, shot from the near point, floats over the net. Rockers trying to get it up and out of the zone. Moore picks it up, shot once again kicked aside. That time, a juicy rebound sitting there. Gullo able to take it away. Gets it out of the zone only for a moment. McDonald has to wait for Moore to get back onside. Puts on the brakes to the far side. Hunter, centering pass, broken up. Chip to the near side. Rockers chasing after it. They'll get a partial change out of this. 4:39 to go, second period. 3-1 Motor City here at Big Boy Arena. Slahetka, one touch pass, too strong and too high for Hunter. Back to the near side. Slahetka keeps it in. Pressured by Smith. Centers to Layton, pass broken up, has a man out in front. King couldn't get it to the stick, and Lane King would have had a breakaway, not to be, pass off the mark.
He could have walked, skipped, hopped, jumped, anything he wanted to do towards the net. He was all alone.
McDonald's shot punched away by Babin. He's trying to figure out where the puck is. Finds Balkwill, shot slid to the far side of the net. River Dragons controlling the pace of play right now. Under 4 minutes to go, second period, and a shot gloved by Trevor Babin. Not a moment too soon for 72. We'll take a quick break with the media timeout. 3:57 to go in the second period. 3-1 Motor City. Ben, shots on goal. And, well, has anyone else done anything around the league?
Yeah, well, right now, shots on goal are going to favor overall Columbus. They now have 19-17. Still getting shot out, though, here in the second period, 13-9. We'll get into why that's significant probably at the intermission, but it's trending a good positive sign for Motor City. Still going on around the league, still 2-0 between Port Huron and Binghamton. We're going to check in at Danbury Arena. Well, the Rabbits just went on a scoring spree thanks to William Berry. He got the last two to make it 3-0, those goals 3 minutes apart in the second period. And of course, Carolina now doubles their lead. Gus Ford adding a goal in the second period at the 3:23 mark for a 2-0 game over Blue Ridge, and it is still 0-0 halfway through the first period at the Raising Cane's Center between Baton Rouge and Mississippi.
Well, Ben, at the risk of sounding a bit arrogant and a bit cocky, if the Rockers play like this, that first round series with Danbury, you can play it in Danbury, you can play it in Fraser, you can play it on a pond, you can play it in Guam for all I care. If the Rockers play like this, I like their chances against the Hat Tricks.
Well, and that's the thing too. You look at it, how does this, you know, how do you build on this for tomorrow, right? And this, and that's how Motor City got their only win against Binghamton. How? They got physical with them here at Big Boy Arena. So I like the foreshadowing. Right now, Motor City has kind of figured out if you want to beat the top teams in the league, you got to amp up the physicality just a little bit, because again, it doesn't take you off your game, because you, it's well within your game. And if you can do that against the top teams, again, bodes well, not only for the weekend, but for tonight as well.
Well, and physicality in the right way. We've seen games against Port Huron get physical, but it was dumb physical at times. Against Binghamton, do a nice job. And I think it goes hand in hand with playing well in the defensive zone. Hey, if you're riding guys into the boards, if you're battling out in front of the net, that's physical,
right.
But that's good defensive hockey. And I don't think it's just a coincidence that, hey, maybe they play a little tighter in the defensive zone, a little more physical, and they've had more success.
Well, and that's just it, though. I mean, you said the distinction. Against your rival, you're going to do dumb things. Why? They get under your skin. It is what it is, right? But against good teams, you know you can't do dumb things. So you are going to get back at them. You are going to play physical, but you're going to play smart. And that's where the inconsistencies lie with Motor City at times. Sometimes they do get too physical, and they are, you know, I won't say dumb, but they're ill-advised at times.
3:15 to go, second period. 3-1, Motor City on top of Columbus. River Dragons have been carrying the play the last handful of minutes. Giuliano goes down. Play goes on. Campbell banks it up to Delaney. He sends into the glove of Colgan. He doesn't like whistles. He plays it once again. But comes into the crease. His hand forced, he covers it up. Offensive zone draw coming for Motor City, but some pushing and shoving in close.
Do you think Brendan Colgan doesn't like whistles because he doesn't know how to whistle?
Is that true?
I don't know.
I didn't know if you had some deep fun fact that he couldn't whistle or something.
No, I'm just being silly. I'm just being silly.
Well, I think part of the reason why he plays it is because he has such a good team around him that more often than not, him playing it behind his own net can lead to an opportunity on the other end and keeping play going when you have these dudes up and down the lineup for Columbus. Hey, you give them more time playing hockey, they're gonna do things well instead of a stop-start game. When Columbus gets into a flow, we've seen them score quickly and rapidly. Heck, the one game we beat Columbus here, we had a very comfortable lead, and then it felt like at a drop of a hat, oh, no, it's a one-goal game again.
Well, again, and that's just it. They can just do that at the snap of a finger. But it's within their game, right? And that's what and they know what Colgan brings. Yes, I'm being silly. I'm sure he knows how to whistle and whistle a very good tune at that. He plays a very good tune in net, in between the pipes. But, you know, again, it's all within the system. He has made a couple of ill-advised passes, but he's keeping the game flowing because, again, all these guys are good, skilled skaters. They can tilt the ice in their favor at any time.
Scramble like right out there in front, and Shinkarik went through the net, and that draws the whistle. We'll get a draw in the Rocker zone, but I know the net, it comes off a lot here at Motor City. That was always going to come off.
That was going to come off no matter what. But, again, speaks to that, right? They tilted the ice, and they had four guys on the rush. Why? All of them skate fast. They skate smooth. So things can turn on a dime. It's, you know, you just got to keep, again, they are going to get their chances. You got to make sure the chances they get, though, are limited. And that's what the difference has been tonight. Columbus hasn't gotten a lot of quality chances.
Columbus Only goals come on the power play. And it was Alexander Jemayev. Rockers found the back of the net three times. That's where we stand. 2:20 to go in the second period. 3-1. Motor City leads Columbus here at Big Boy Arena. Trying to snap a lengthy winning streak for Columbus for the second time this season. Gullo along the near boards, pressured by a pair of River Dragons. Vanderweel comes in to clean up the puck. Surveys the scene, gets it through a couple of white jerseys to Koash. Short feed to the near side. King centering shot. Smith whiff shot, rings the doorbell. Oh, he had the spot, just put it a hair too wide.
That's a college miss. That's not a miss on Avery. That is a hard goal in it to get, and that's just a college miss. You see that all the time in the college game. He just missed it literally by a half inch, if that.
I love the way the Rockers are winning the puck battles and setting up opportunities like that. 90 seconds to go in the period. McDonald, rink-wide feed, hops over the stick of Ryan Hunter. Back behind the net. McDonald, no one in front of him. Backhand saved by Babin from point blank. Puck sent all the way into the River Dragon zone. A round of applause for Trevor Babin and the Rockers defense. In front, shot misses up and wide. Ooh, that's a pretty good opportunity for Ryan Hunter.
Well, that hit, that definitely hit the post.
Columbus battling out in front as Layton couldn't get the all of that one-timer. Puck sent all the way down, and right now feels like Motor City just needs to get these 50 seconds off the clock. River Dragons are buzzing. McDonald, he's been on the ice for a while. Pass taken away by Conway. Back into the zone. McDonald drops it off. Give and go. McDonald, shot deflected. Heck of a job by Jonathan Giuliano, the veteran, just getting in the way enough to alter the shot.
Well, it was perfect. He came back, circled towards it, knew where McDonald was hunting, and got his stick on it.
Pass to the point. Underwood chips in deep. 23 seconds left to go in the period. Fields leaves it for Giuliano. Flips it up and, oh, it did touch the rafters. Giuliano is saying, no, it did not. That's a big difference, because if that puck keeps play going, the River Dragons might have time for one rush if they hurry. Now they get an offensive zone draw with 17.4 on the clock.
Well, yeah, and, you know, not only is that, again, we've talked about it, Motor City does struggle with faceoffs, and, you know, if you can tie this one up, maybe get a clear, get icing down, that's a win in the regard. Just, again, survive the last 17.4. And they do. They tie up the faceoff.
We get a whistle.
What?
Going to get a hand pass call.
If it's on Strojahan, that's a win. I'll take that.
Or are they giving it to Strojahan? He's the one that seems upset.
Well,
Strojahan is confused. The captain, Petrantonio.
Yeah, it's outside the zone.
Yeah, talking with the official, and that'll move it outside the zone.
Hey, what a win. I'll take it.
The official made a very...
I will take that.
A very confident call. The question is, you're going to the box, are they going to give him 2 minutes? Did he grasp the hand around the puck?
I would love that.
Owen Petrantonio, is he going to the box? Or he's going to talk to the official?
I think he's just talking to the official. I think that's what they're discussing right now, if he closed his hand, and if he did. That's like going to your favorite store on a two-for-one sale and finding the item half off.
That's the Kowalski Meat Locker is open. Are they going to grab anyone?
Well,
Strojahan.
He's going in.
Taking a long, lonely stroll.
And it is. It's going
to
be
the box.
It's going to be clasping his hand on the hand pass.
And with 13.5 left to go in the second period, Storjahan goes to the Kowalski Meat Locker, and the Rockers go on the Genesis Credit Union power play. Learn how Genesis Credit Union can help you save your money by visiting GenesisCU.com or any of their convenient locations located near you.
Yep, closing the hand on the puck. That is the official call.
Petrantonio is vehemently arguing. He did not like the call, as that stops all River Dragon momentum.
Well, that's better than a face-off win.
Off the draw, Motor City collects it. Miguel Diaz, 10 seconds to go in the period. To the left wing circle, Delaney. Takes his time, 5 seconds, shot, and it's saved. Rebound, Vanderweel tried to center. 1 second, and we will head to the third. Rockers lead it 2-1 as Miguel Diaz
and
Sequoia Swan have words for each other.
He threw a punch.
And Jerome Bouchard nearly ran onto the ice. And we'll see how they settle it out. It looks like the peace has been restored. Well, they're telling everyone to head to their locker rooms. We'll see how the officials sort this out.
Trevor Babin Swan threw a punch.
Jameson Milam, veteran move. He got in front of Trevor Babin.
Well, but again, Trevor's sticking up for a guy. We saw it last weekend, too, when Kyle Moore was roughing up Nick Gullo on, what was it, Sunday or Saturday? I forget. Either way, Trevor Babin's going to stick up for a teammate. And when you sucker punch someone like that, like Sequoia Swan just did to Nick Gullo, that is garbage. That is Bush League. Like, what is that? I don't understand that. You know, yes, you can jaw back and forth, but when you sucker punch someone like that, that's awful. That is poor form. That is terrible.
Well, after 40 minutes of play, it's 3-1 Motor City. Ben, let's take a look at shots on goal and how we got to 3-1 here in the second period.
Well, shots on goal favor Motor City 14-11. Why is that important, Brady? Well, because last week throughout three games, in the second period, they totaled 17 shots on goal. So Motor City did a little bit better than that. So they had 14 in the second period tonight to Columbus's 11. They're trailing, though, overall 21-18, but they're leading on the scoreboard. Second period scoring, Danny Vanderweel got the first one at the minute 50 mark to make it 2-0 for Motor City. It was then a rebound goal on the power play 3 minutes later. Alexander Jemayev getting one in, but guess what? No assist by number 7. It was assisted by Cody Wickline and Ryan Hunter. So that streak is 20 minutes away from ending, an historic streak for Justin McDonald. But again, anything can happen. And then finally, 40 seconds after that, Nick Miguel Diaz with a pretty snipe made it 3-1. That's how we got to 3-1 here. It is 3-0 Danbury over Watertown, 2-0 Port Huron over Binghamton, 3-0 Carolina over Blue Ridge, and the Voodoo Generals lead 2-0 over the Zydeco.
Fans, if you're in attendance or if you come to a game, be sure to stay after the game for the 3 stars of the game and an opportunity to catch a Star of the Game t-shirt courtesy of Lasting Impressions Promotional Marketing, a family-owned Michigan business. 40 minutes in the book, and the Rockers have a 3-1 lead over the top team in the Fed, the Columbus River Dragons. We'll step aside. We'll come back with third period action in a bit. You're watching the Motor City Rockers Media Network. Ronald Shocker's your local Farm Bureau insurance agent located in Shelby Township. They've been protecting and providing Michigan families with auto, home, life, and health insurance since 2016. For all your insurance needs, trust Michigan Farm Bureau agent Ronald Shocker. The Motor City Rockers trusted Nick Miguel Diaz. He got the Ronald Shocker insurance goal to make it 3-1 Motor City. And after 40 minutes of play, the Rockers have the River Dragons on the ropes. The Rockers are almost perfect this year when they lead after two periods. They have lost just one game in regulation, and that was partially due because they had to make a goaltender change. But 19-1-3 when they lead after 40 minutes. That's a pretty good trend, and means the Rockers, hopefully, if it continues, get 3 points here tonight.
And it would be a big 3 points, right? Because as of right now, what's happening in Danbury's not looking good if you're a Rocker fan. Still a 3-0 game near the end of the second period there. But, again, you hold your fate in your own hands. You win games, guess what? All the pressure's on Danbury. They're the ones that got to catch you, not the other way around.
Right now, all the pressure's on Columbus. We did get word during the break. We will go 4-on-4. Nick Miguel Diaz gets 2 minutes for slashing. So for all intents and purposes, that negates the Storjahan penalty for grasping the hand on the puck. And they will get a 13-second power play, but basically back to even strength hockey until the next penalty's called.
Yeah, and again, you know, would have liked it if they called the sucker punch from Sequoia Swan, but he did disguise it pretty well. So I'll give Sequoia credit there. But, instead, boy, Nick Miguel Diaz will go in for slashing, which caused it. But, you know, Motor City's doing okay. The only power play goal, and again, they only had one power play opportunity, so they're 1-for-1. But it came on the rebound, right? It was just good positioning by Alexander Jemayev. Motor City's been good at gathering the puck, gathering rebounds, and getting clears. Just stick with that formula. Don't change anything with that. You'll survive. But if you only have 13 seconds of 5-on-4 hockey, that's not a bad thing either. You just got to survive for 13 seconds.
It will be a 13-second Insight Healthcare penalty kill for all your medical needs around Southeast Michigan. Go to Insight Healthcare and get some insight to your health today. But, Ben, again, you mentioned the Danbury score.
Yep.
And I'll reiterate the point that if the Rockers want to play like the first 40 minutes in this game, if Danbury has home ice, that doesn't scare me as much as maybe it did a couple weeks ago. This has been probably the best 40 minutes since, the last time Motor City beat Columbus.
I mean, they looked good when they beat Binghamton, right?
They played well, but against, when you bring in the quality of opponent into play as well, they played well against some teams that maybe aren't as strong. But this has been a very solid 40 minutes for Motor City.
It has been.
I really like what I've seen through two periods.
Well, again, maybe if you want to play devil's advocate, a solid 38 minutes, because again, at the end of the period, for the first and second, Columbus just turns it on. And that's what they do, though. They can do that. They got the horses. They got the talent. They can do that. So, again, 38 minutes, 40 minutes, Motor City's playing well. They have a two-goal lead. Even when the power play goal brought it within a one-goal lead, Nick Miguel Diaz answered 40 seconds later to get it back to a two. Motor City's not flinching. Motor City is taking a playoff game, basically, and just reveling in it. And we didn't see that opportunity last year, so there's some also personal growth between what happened on Sunday and what's happening tonight. You love to see it. You really do.
Mention it every time the Rockers are in this position. But, man, the first 5 minutes of this period are going to be big. You know the River Dragons are going to come out flying. They're going to come out trying to get one back pretty quickly, survive those first 5 minutes. There's going to be open ice with 4-on-4 for the first minute 47.
And that's going to favor Columbus. I mean, Columbus skates fast. They skate well. And so, yeah, you do. It's not even the first 4 minutes. You got to survive the first two. Columbus can definitely take advantage of this. And right now, also, just want to give people an update. There's three players on Columbus that are hurt. There's number 89, Brody Duncan, possibly has a separated shoulder, but don't know if he'll be back. Hunter Bersani might not be back. And number 91, Carter Shinkarik, was also seen in the tunnel on the injury bench. So that's two defensemen and a forward.
Underwood shot gloved out of the air by Trevor Babin. 14 seconds into the third period. River Dragons were controlling the play a little bit at the end of the period, but Trevor Babin, he's been helped out by his defense, and when he's been asked to make a big save, he's been almost perfect.
Well, yeah. And again, the only time he was beat was on a rebound that he was out of position for,
and
right?
And it was a power play. It happens against a team like Columbus.
Well, it happens in any league, right?
Slap shot swallowed by Babbitt. He wasn't sure he had it, but he did between the wickets, and another draw coming in the rocker zone.
That's a nice heavy rip there by Underwood. Kirk Underwood has got a good shot.
There's a lot of guys white sweaters that have a good shot. He does, and surprisingly, he's one of the guys that hasn't tallied a ton of goals, just 4 on the season, but 18 assists. There's only one puck on the ice for all those goal scorers. In the rocker zone, battling. Back to Underwood. Pass across, ball will miss the mark. Motor City looking to move it up and out of zone. Pass hops over the stick of Milam. Underwood gives it right back to Milam. Vanderweel races after it. We have 1:05 left to go to the penalty for Columbus. Now 1:13 left to go to the penalty for Motor City. 50 seconds into the third period.
Well, here comes Hunter using his speed. Gives it to Shinkarik. So good to see Shinkarik back. That's nice.
Passed it to, well, no one in particular. Rockers were able to send it out of the zone only for the moment. River Dragons touch up Shinkarik to the far side. Koash chasing after it. Near side, Layton walks in, shot, tip, scores. Believe Cody Wickline got a piece of it.
Yes, he did.
And a minute and 11 seconds into the third, the River Dragons pull within one. Wickline with his 19th of the year lifted it up and right into the corner. Nothing Trevor Babin could do. And it's 3-2 Motor City. That's what we talked about, surviving the early part of this period. The River Dragons came out, controlled play, and they're rewarded for it with the goal.
Well, Parker Layton's going to get his first point. He was the one who fired the shot, so maybe save the puck for him. Congratulations to the young man getting his first point.
30 seconds of 4-on-4 hockey. Pietrantonio nearly lost it at his feet, able to recover. Give and go to the far side. Gives back to Layton. Rippers kicked aside by Babin. Picking it up, uncontested, T.J. Delaney into the neutral zone. Pietrantonio knocks it away. Turnover, Delaney shoots, scores! T.J.
Wow.
Delaney takes advantage of the mistake, and the Rockers get it right back.
Well, it took 40 seconds the last time. It only took 20 seconds this time to rebuild the lead back to 2. And Josh Pietrantonio, not happy about it, ran into T.J. Delaney, gave him a little bit of a reverse check, but that's a big answer.
And that's just a bad turnover. That's a pass that you just flubbed on. Brody Duncan back out on the ice, and, well, T.J. Delaney took advantage of the opportunity. Ben, I feel like in games earlier in the season, the Rockers hadn't converted on those chances as often as they have tonight. And man, that's deflating for Columbus. They get one back, and then a self-inflicted wound. T.J. Delaney, he nets another one, 24 on the year.
Well, let's give T.J. some credit, though. He offered the forechecking pressure, forced the issue, and the Columbus player looked up, and that's why he flubbed on the pass. He saw a 6'7 guy coming barreling down at him. That's just a good play by Delaney. So we're going to give him credit where credit's due.
Wickline had a couple looks at the net, went wide. And yeah, you put yourself in position for luck to matter.
Yep.
To take advantage of mistakes. 17:43 left to go, third period. We're back to 5-a-side hockey. 4-2 Motor City on top of Columbus here on a Friday night at Big Boy Arena.
Well, and just because we have to check, I want to see who got the secondary assist. No, it's going to be Nolan Schlaheka. I saw a 7 on there. I thought, again, Justin McDonald riding that 38-game point streak. He has yet to record a point tonight, so got to keep an eye on that. Because some broadcasters in this booth think that people don't pay attention to the entire league. And I say, that's balderdash.
Well, Justin McDonald, it's hard not to pay attention to him. 39 goals, 68 assists, 107 points on the year. You can't not pay attention to that.
No. I mean, what he's doing is absolutely insane. I mean, it really is. He's a created player playing NHL 24. He really is. He's just – he's a guy who gets in good position. He sets up his teammates. I mean, a guy who gets 68 assists in a season, that's incredible. It really is incredible. He's just everywhere on the ice, good positioning, helping his teammates. It's not luck. It's not accident.
Rockers have done a nice job neutralizing him so far. Shot from Hunter, padded away. Rebound out in front. Rockers scrambling. They flip it to the neutral ice. Give Babin a moment to breathe. Smith chases after it. Pass near side. Moore touches it. Pass this outstretched stick of Campbell. Trevor Babin caresses the puck. Freezes, and with 17:09 to go in the third period, get another draw in the Rocker zone.
Well, Kyle Moore wants something. I don't know what he wants. This benefits Columbus. Didn't see anything. So, you
draw
see anything?
I do not know what the politicking was for. All I know is the draw is coming to the left of Trevor Babin, Justin McDonald. On the dot for Columbus. Tie up on the draw. McDonald boxed out by the veteran Giuliano. Giuliano, he's the epitome sometimes of work smarter, not harder. He gets in the right position and is rewarded for it.
I mean, he's a guy last year. And again, this season, it's all playing with free money, literally, for Jonathan Giuliano. Last year, had a health scare. His season was cut short. He thought his career was going to be cut short. And he's playing like it. I mean, he's playing with a high hockey IQ that he's always had. And he's making the most of an opportunity he did not think he would get again.
Turned over. Knocked away. Ryan Hunter had it. Lost it. Moore battling for it. On the far half wall. Slides to the blue line. Back to Hunter. Trying to stick handle. Shot goes well over the crossbar over Trevor Babin's head. Motor City. Working in neutral ice. Puck goes up in the air. Conway lost his stick. He chases after it. Shot slides to the far side of Trevor Babin. 16:08 to go, third period. Motor City 4, Columbus 2. And we get a whistle. After the first two periods had a lot of flow, this start of the third, then pretty stop-start. Have had a fair bit of whistles through the first 4 minutes.
Yeah, but, I'm okay with that. I really am. I'm okay with the start and stop action. Doesn't allow Columbus getting into a rhythm. Because that's what terrifies you as a Rocker fan. When you see this team skating and just gliding through the zone, getting into opportunities, if you can stop that, get them into a traffic jam, that's not anything that you're going to scoff at. You'll appreciate it.
On their own blue line, Alexander Jemayev. He was the first River Dragon to light the lamp, takes it into the offensive zone. To the far side. Shot knocked away. Pietrantonio tried to center right back to his stick on the backhand. Poked away. That time it was Lane King coming down helping on the back check.
Man, Pietrantonio just got rocked.
Fields drove him into the boards. He's slow to get up. Grabs the stick. Behind the net, Danny Vanderweel slides it along the near boards. Lane King looking for someone to send it to. Off the mark to Declan Conway. Brody Duncan back out on the ice after he left in the middle of the second period. Controls play. To the far side, Anderson. Pass broken up. Rockers control it. Koash patiently takes his time, now uses his speed over all three lines. Right wing circle. Shot misses wide of the net. Kept in by Colton. All the way around to the far side. Smith drops back. Fields comes up. Smith can't keep the puck in. 5 minutes into the third period. Each side has lit the lamp. And it's a 4-2 game. 14:49 to go in the third period. That'll take us to a media timeout. FanSaves and the Rockers have partnered to help save you money. Go to the App Store on your phone, download the FanSaves app, and follow the Motor City Rockers, and you're on your way to scoring deals with our partners. Our winger of the game tonight, Nick Gullo, he hasn't scored, but if they do, you'll get buy one, get one boneless wings from B-Dubs. Just show them the app when you order to claim your prize. Let's throw it over to Ben for shots on goal and scores around the Fed.
Well, shots on goal, Columbus dominating the third period. They're also now getting the lead overall in the game. In the third period, 7-1 overall in the game, 28-19. So 9 more shots than Motor City. Motor City, though, leads where it matters, 4-2 on the scoreboard. Binghamton got one back. Port Huron, though, leading the Black Bears 3-1. More importantly, though, Watertown. We said that they're feisty, Brady. They're only trailing by two. They have two goals. Danbury has four. The hat trick's leading that one by two. Carolina all over Blue Ridge, 4-0, and Mississippi still carrying the tune as the Seawolves have a 2-0 lead at the Raising Cane Center of the Zydeco.
Here at Big Boy Arena, Rockers putting up one of their best performances so far tonight. They lead it 4-2 over Columbus River Dragons, winners of seven straight. And in that streak, three over Motor City. You know the Rockers are motivated to finish this one out.
Well, I will say this. Get a birthday cake ready if Motor City wins for Gordy Brown. It's his birthday. It's also George Blaha's birthday. How do you like that?
Happy birthday to Coach Brown. I'm sure he'd love nothing more than a win over the league's top team for a birthday present. Rockers have sure played like they want to deliver that to Coach Brown. In the offensive zone for Columbus Fields. Short pass behind the net. Gullo feeds, gets it right back from Colton. Up to the near side, Devon Fields. Still in his own zone. Shovels it to neutral. Lice sent back in by Underwood. Babin comes out of the crease to play it. Leaves it for Colton. Sends it to the far corner. Gullo watches it to the tape. Back to the near side. And well, the River Dragons forechecking pressure has been all over the Rockers. They get it out of the zone. Colton to Fields. A couple of D-men leading the charge. Fields off the wall. Colton chips it back. Battle for it. Colton gets it back to Svintsov. Stick handles. Pass out in front. And they couldn't get it on the stick of Delaney. Colton lays a check. The net comes off. Balkwell didn't like the hit from Colton. And we'll have some more hands being thrown. Looks like it'll stay to five-a-side hockey. The temper's starting to flare up once again.
Well, I said Brendan Colgan was seeing ghosts. Well, I now start to believe the River Dragon defensemen have a couple of Rockers under their skin, because there is an itch that they would like to scratch, and they can't do it. They just can't. I mean, right now you're seeing things like Balkwell doing that. Josh Colton didn't do anything really malicious. The net got knocked off the moorings, and there was some extracurriculars from both sides. Columbus is not focused right now, and it's really surprising. Motor City, though, the more physical of the two teams, just dictating the pace of this game, which, again, can turn at, you know, a snap of a finger, but really impressive so far what Motor City has done.
Columbus has dictated a little bit of the pace here in the third with a score 1-1 here in the third, 4-2 overall. Rockers, offensive zone possession. Colton centers. Delaney on the backhand pushes it wide of the net.
Colgan just swiped at Giuliano.
In close, Giuliano back behind the net, gives to the far side. Delaney's shot is lifted up into the protective netting. They'll get another whistle and another draw to our left in the River Dragons end. Both sides make a line change. You have King, Steve, Conway, Milam, and Nick Miguel Diaz coming out for Motor City. Looks like Slahetka, McDonald, along with Layton, Ryan Hunter out there as well with Kyle Moore for Columbus. On the far dot. Clean win for Columbus. They bank it up and out of the zone. Goes over all three lines. Babin elects to play it outside the crease. Long pass to center ice. Racing after it. Parker Layton, no icing called. King, nearly had the turnover. Would have had Sneath coming in as it stands. It's frozen by Colgan, and we'll get another offensive zone draw for Motor City.
Yeah, not bad. Again, but Motor City, what really helped them, though, so far in this game is the forecheck. Mm-hmm. They've been just really aggressive. And, again, that is Columbus's game. Oh, here we go. Brendan Colgan being the gamesmanship, checking the equipment. We haven't seen this move from Colgan in a while.
Well, it doesn't take too long.
No, but it's gamesmanship, right? It freezes the game. That's what I appreciate. And this sounds sarcastic, and I tell you, I'm not being sarcastic. I appreciate when Brendan Colgan does that. It allows his guys to reset, allows everyone to kind of breathe, That's good gamesmanship. I don't like it when goaltenders knock the net off the moorings.
Oh, there's some bad blood on the far side. Hunter not getting along with Conway, and I think that's going to cost McDonald the draw.
Well, it should.
Oof. Offensive zone draw. Hunter throws the body around. Sneath goes down. Play stays in the offensive zone. Miguel Diaz, shot deflected. Sticked aside by Colgan. Hunter in his own zone. Feeds up the near side to Kyle Moore. Back to Nick Miguel Diaz. Works around the defender. At his own blue line, battling with Moore. Slides it to Lane King. Feeds up to Conway. Center of the ice between the legs of Lane King. Behind the end line for Columbus. River Dragons pick it up. McDonald to center ice, shoveled ahead. Nick Miguel Diaz in his own zone. Long feed along the boards. Ends up with Slahetka. River Dragons chasing two. Pushed off the puck, Gullo. Pinned across the boards. And another battle. It's getting feisty. Turnover. Rockers going the other way. Smith, left wing circle, shot deflected. Gullo waves at it, doesn't do much. Slahetka far side, battles with Smith. It's sent all the way back to the Rockers' end, and Motor City will reset with 12:03 to go third period, 4-2 Motor City. Petriantonio picked it up on the blue line, shot right into the mitt of Trevor Babin. He saw that one all the way, and Trevor Babin didn't like whatever he interpreted Sequoia Swan doing. And is that going to send Swan to the box? I think it is.
Yeah, Swan swiped. It's going to be slashing on Swan. He swiped that Babin as he blew by the tower. Yeah, there it is, slashing. That's the call.
And that's just a bad penalty to take.
Well, it's a dumb penalty to take.
That's not one in the flow of the game.
No.
And that's going to, and they just sent someone out. Did Jerome Brichard just get tossed, or someone on that Columbus bench just got?
Oh, it's an assistant coach. I think that's Jay Krupp. That looks like Krupp.
Officials were done with it.
That looks like Jay Krupp. Bouchard's asking for it, though, too. He's talking with the officials. Chris Rowe telling Jay Krupp, no, your day's done.
So going to the Kowalski Meat Locker, Sequoia Swan. Rockers go on the Genesis Credit Union Power Play. Learn how Genesis can help you grow your money at genesiscu.com. And Jay Krupp, well, he doesn't have to go to the meat locker, but he has to go back to the locker room. And right now, I feel like the Rockers are moving downhill. If they can net one in these 2 minutes, man, would that feel like a backbreaker with under 12 to go. Cleared all the way down the ice by Brody Duncan. Sent to Milam. Near side, Danny Vanderweel, the captain, behind his own net using his speed. Drop pass for Miguel Diaz. Works around Petriantonio into the offensive zone. Miguel Diaz to Milam. Left wing circle. Left back for Giuliano. Back to Milam. Near hash marks. Vanderweel chips it back to Milam. Sets it down off the glove.
Really would like Motor City to get into a set here. Their power play's been lacking.
Milam shot sent up into the net. 1:22 left to go in the Swan slashing minor. 11:19 to go in the game. 4-2. Motor City on top. But it does feel a little bit like Columbus, a bit frustrated, a bit on their heels. And a goal here might just exacerbate that. And, well, anytime you get a 3-goal lead in the third period, you feel a lot better. But especially against these River Dragons, you'll take all the insurance you can get.
Well, yeah, but this is a good opportunity for Motor City to do just that. Their power play has not been great as of late. Again, slipping from first to third. And if you can get one here on the power play, it helps rebuild that confidence, getting your system, making sure that it works right before the playoffs. So it'd be nice to get one here for that reason as well.
Koash settles it down, sends it behind the net. Conway, sandwiched by a couple of River Dragons, able to return it to Koash. Minute left to go and the man advantage. Cross crease pass, can't find Colton. Turned over on the forecheck. Colton can't settle it down, and the River Dragons get it out of the zone, but not all the way down the ice. Keeps those four penalty killers on the ice for Columbus. Horseshoeing it around the boards to Conway. Picked up by Colton. Left back for King. He's able to keep it in the zone. 37 seconds left to go to we're back to five-a-side hockey. Columbus picks up the puck. Storjahan taking a moment, letting that clock milk away. Gives to Underwood back behind his own net. Banks it off the board, but right to Danny Vanderweel. Doesn't get the full clear. Koash brings it in. He dumps in deep as the Rockers make a bit of a change. 15 seconds left to go in the Genesis Credit Union power play.
Well, you got out of the power play set. You just have a normal lineup here. See what you can do with it.
Milam, far corner, tried to center. It was kicked away. Final seconds come off the clock. Sequoia Swan out of the box. He's waiting at the other blue line. Rockers identified it right away. 9:50 to go, third period. 4-2, Motor City on top. Wickline, backhand, taken away. Heck of a job once again by Danny Vanderweel. Man, ever since he's come back, he hasn't lit it up on the point sheet, but if you're watching these games, you know number 19 has been an integral part to this Rockers squad.
Well, again, he's the heart and soul of this team. When he was on IR, this team was a sub-500 team. That's not a coincidence. And when he came back, he lit a fire under this team. He does it with his play. Ooh, I thought that was maybe going to be a goal. But, again, he does it with his play. And you have to love him for it. He's a guy who gives you 110% when he's on the ice, leads by example. You love it. You just absolutely love it. And as of late, the past 3 weeks, he's really been turning it on.
9:05 to go, third period. Rockers could get a big 3 points tonight as they battle for second place in the division and home ice. And we've got a brouhaha right in front of us. Moore has Smith in a headlock. McDonald has words. He throws a left hand. Moore with the right hand to Smith. We got two guys going at it. Smith's telling Moore he'll drop the gloves. And we'll see what sorts out of all of this. Frustration's boiling over. Sequoia Swan steps up to Avery Smith, and they're going to dance. Welcome to the Fed, Avery Smith, going one-on-one with Sequoia Swan at center ice. They circle. Smith sizing up Swan. Throws a right, Swan ducks it. Swan lands a right and another. Smith gets one in. Throwing a few more, switching to the left. Swan gets a left in. Smith on his heels and Swan takes down Smith. As Sequoia Swan will go right back to the Kowalski meat locker. Avery Smith just endeared himself to the band here at Big Boy Arena. He gets one of the loudest ovations of the night.
Love it. Don't love what I saw by Tristan Wells. That was a clear cross check at center ice that started everything. But you know what? This has been brewing since last weekend. Motor City finally saying they're not going to be pushed around. Motor City, love it. And how do you not love Avery Smith? In the time he's been here, it's 6 games, including today. It's 2 weekends. It's 2 weekends, Brady. And he's been playing like he's been a Rocker ever since he was born. You got to love that.
And Sequoia Swan, he's one of the tougher guys in the league. And there's not a lot of young guys, a lot of new guys to the league that are going to drop the gloves with a guy like Sequoia Swan. All the respect in the world to Avery Smith. Hey, Swan got the better of him this time, but he went toe-to-toe. He got a few blows in, and you'll love to see that. That's leading by example, because they were talking. Swan stepped up, and Smith said, all right, let's do it.
I'm going to have a slight disagreement with you, Brady. If you're a tough guy, you take the helmet off in a fight. Sequoia Swan did not do that. That's all I'm going to say.
8:57 to go in the third period. 2 minutes go on the board for Motor City. Tristan Wells heading to the box, and the Rockers look like they're going to go on the Insight Healthcare penalty kill. If you're not feeling yourself, go to Insight Healthcare and get some insight to your health today.
But that's the right decision, though. Give Tristan Wells the cross-checking penalty he deserves.
And the draw should come in the Rocker zone. And another chance for Columbus to bring it within one. One for one on the penalty. Well, technically one for two.
Yep.
But for all intents and purposes, they're one for one. I know in the stat books it says one for two, but 13 seconds after a four on four, forgive me if I'm going to say that that's not number one on the best penalty kills of the year for Motor City.
Yeah. No, I mean, you're not wrong, Brady.
Off the draw. It goes back to neutral ice. McDonald picks it up. McDonald spinning around up the near side to Moore. Chips in deep, backhanded by Babin. He settles it down, covers it up. 16 seconds into the power play. And we'll go to a media timeout. It's been a minute. Ben, I'm sure something's happened around the Fed. Let's take a look at those shots.
Yeah, we'll take a look at the shots here in just a moment. Just got to wait for the browser to catch up. Okay, Columbus still leads Motor City 8-2. Overall, 29-20. Again, Motor City leading where it matters, 4-2 here at Big Boy Arena. Port Huron just pouring it on.
Man, they needed won, that win.
They won that game in a big, big way. As you said, Brady, they needed it. They beat Binghamton 4-0. First start of the game was Jake Vaughn, the new kid, got a goal. Makar Sokolov only allowed one goal, made 39 saves. He was your second star of the night. Liam Freeborn was your third star. Let's check in at Danbury Arena. It's still a 4-2 game. Watertown has a goal, two of which came off the stick of Carter Thornton. But, again, Danbury has a 4-2 lead there. It's a 4-0 lead, Carolina leading Blue Ridge. And it's a 3-1 game, Mississippi Seawolves over the Zydeco.
4-2 here, Motor City leads Columbus. 1:44 left to go in the Insight Healthcare penalty kill. Tristan Wells in the box for a cross check. Columbus trying to get back within one. Rockers have led this one basically all the way. They've never trailed.
No, they haven't. Every time Columbus pulled within one, Motor City's built it back to two.
And within a minute as well. Balkwill, far side. Petrantonio has to settle the puck down. Left wing circle. Slides it to the end line. Pass in front. Pinballs around. Stays in play. And then Storjahan on the near half wall. Walks it in. Almost lost his balance. Gives to McDonald on the near hash mark. Searches. Rink wide feet. Hops over the stick of Petrantonio. 1:15 left to go on the penalty kill. The Columbus captain takes his time back to the point. Near side, McDonald. To the point, Balkwill. Far side, Petrantonio. Slides it, poked away, picked up. Columbus controlled the pace. Balkwill's shot goes high and wide. Rebound picked up by McDonald. Haven't gotten many shots on net here on this power play. There's one kicked aside by Babin, and a much-needed clear for Motor City. They'll get a change. 45 seconds to back to even strength hockey.
Yeah, Lane King did a good job. Did not waste any time clearing that puck all the way down 175 feet.
35 seconds on the Wells Minor, racing over all three lines. Hunter back to the far point, spinning around. Shinkarik gives back to Hunter, and Fields puts him on the ice. Devon Fields races after it, feeds up to Giuliano. He's on his horse, left wing circle, didn't have the angle, shot it from a negative angle, tried to bank it off the shoulder of Colgan, but even so, that takes us down to 10 seconds on the penalty kill.
Love it.
Hunter takes it in deep, Fields throwing the body around once again. You hear the stick ring out from Brendan Colgan, and Tristan Wells comes out of the box. Shot, and a
what
lot of contact. Out
what
in
is
front,
that?
Danny Vanderweel didn't like Jemayev essentially body slamming Trevor Babin.
That's a bulldog. That's not a body slam. That's a bulldog. He jumped up, grabbed his head, and tried to slam it to the ice.
I'm going to give Jemayev the benefit of the doubt. I don't know if there was ill intent. He was just, I think he was trying to get in front to tip it. But anybody with a C on their chest worth their weight, anytime you have a guy land on top of your goalie, you're going to have to let him know about it.
Well, his body language shows I don't think it was accidental. Maybe 6-1, half dozen of the other there. But Motor City's doing their talking on the scoreboard and elsewhere. So Trevor Babin's a big boy. He'll just shake it off and he'll be all right.
It'll stay 5-on-5 hockey. Wickline off the draw, misses high and wide. Conway races after it, can't get to the puck in time. Columbus keeps possession as it goes back up and out of play. 6:45 to go in the third period. Rockers 4, Columbus 2. Again, Columbus, magic number to clinch the Continental, 3. So if they got a regulation win tonight, they would celebrate a Continental division title. But right now, Motor City trying to stave off that party.
Good to see Bersani back out there.
Every River Dragon that went into the locker room has come back out.
Good to see him.
Colgan plays it behind his own net to the far side. Conway couldn't keep it on the boards. Storjahan battles for it along with Sneath. Conway trying to dig it out. Columbus comes away with it. Wickline, near side. Backhands it to the far boards. Racing in the offensive zone, Brody Duncan. Chips in deep. Vanderweel cuts him off. Backhands it to the far side. Conway has room to work. McDonald comes to pressure. Long feed. Koash on the backhand shoots, and it's knocked away by Colgan. He didn't catch it with the trapper, but got enough with it to keep it at 4-2. Koash picks it up deep, centers, and it's kicked aside by the River Dragons. Rockers keep it in the zone once again. Gullo takes it away. Shot into the chest of Colgan. And a much-needed whistle for Columbus. Still 4-2, but Motor City not sitting back on their heels. They're going on the offensive.
Again, why would you? This is a team that you got, if you're drilling into the dirt, you got to keep drilling until the bell rings. They can get up and turn the tide on you in an instant. Motor City just needs to keep going. John Henry versus the steam engine, right? Just keep going in with your sledgehammer. Keep going in until you go to the other side. What other analogy do you want?
I like it.
I didn't hear bell.
Be a steel driving man.
I was going to say. Well, I got them all in my back pocket for you. I figured I'd throw the John Henry out there because it hasn't been talked about in a while.
5:40 to go in the third period. 4-2. Motor City on top. They've never trailed in this one. Columbus trying to pull within one. Into the rocker zone, it's knocked away from McDonald. Delaney chips it over all three lines, picking it up, Kirk Underwood. To the far side, pass, can't find Balkul. Delaney centers at the feet of Svintsov. He tried to turn and fire. Colgan able to get on top of that, and more pushing and shoving. Balkul and Delaney exchanging pleasantries.
Well, Delaney's getting whitewashed by two people.
Order looks to have been restored for the moment, and I don't think anyone's going to either box. We'll get two new lines coming out on the ice. 5:18 to go in the third. TJ Delaney still a bit hot. The linesmen have to escort him all the way to the Rockers bench. And Delaney still throwing words back at Balkwell. Last time these two teams are meeting in the regular season. So unless they meet in the Commissioner's Cup Finals, they won't see each other until next year.
Nope.
Draw to the right of Colgan on the tie-up. To the wall, Conway trying to poke that out. Slides out, Vanderweel chips in deep. Colgan puts the stick on it. Far side, Layton to the near wing. Turnover shot, King, and it's swallowed up by Colgan. 5 minutes left to go in the third period. 4-2 Motor City on top. As I talked about earlier in the broadcast, this is the last weekend Ben and I will be together on the TV side of things because the Rockers will be on the radio starting with their next set of games up in Port Huron. And if you're a business owner interested in joining the radio broadcast on 101 FM AM 1400 WDTK The Patriot, get a hold of us. We are selecting one business to win a playoff partnership package worth over $750 that includes radio spots, tickets to the playoffs. Just drop your business card and enter to win at the Rockers merch store. All that said, Ben, one final look at the shots and the out-of-town scoreboard.
Well, that's where Columbus is leading 10-6 in the period, 31-24. Again, you know they're trailing 4-2. Again, it's a 4-1 final at McMoran Place. Port Huron getting a much-needed win over Binghamton. Still 4-2, Danbury over Watertown. Carolina now, it's 5-0 over Blue Ridge. They lost power on Friday. They're playing with power tonight. And, of course, Mississippi now leads 3-1. The Zydeco got one back.
Draw to the right of Brendan Colgan once again. coming down the stretch. Sneath off the draw, and we'll get a whistle. Guy's a little anxious to get these final 5 minutes underway.
Love to see how this one will end. On Sunday, Carolina battled hard in the last 5 minutes. That's how they got the win on Sunday. Let's see what Motor City can do here in the last five. They've been playing well the whole game. Just got to close it out because Columbus has been playing well at the end of every period so far tonight.
Petrantonio trying to get deep for the stretch pass, way off the mark, and icing called. And as this clock gets closer and closer to triple zeros, you're going to see a little more desperation from Columbus. As it looks like Avery Smith all tended up in the penalty box. He got cut up a little bit. Again, he's going to have a scar, but I've liked just about everything I've seen out of 21 from Motor City. I'm hoping he's going to be a big part of a playoff run, and I hope we see a lot more of him in the purple and black.
I was going to say, I'd love to see him next year.
He has been a very welcome addition, and not one you expect to get this late into the season, even with the college signings. 4:51 to go, third period, off the draw. Petrantonio kicks it to his stick. Into the offensive zone, Petrantonio right into the glove of Trevor Babin. And Motor City, no problem inching this period along.
And Indiana Tech, again, this year they were a top 25 team, top 20 actually. They got to number 18 in the country. Very good squad, but the funny thing is, why couldn't we poke a little, like get two more guys from Adrian? Adrian won the national title. Devon Fields played at Adrian. Let's get some of his friends. Why not?
Well,
got two more spots to fill, I will say that.
I like what we've picked up so far. Played a big part in why Motor City's winning this one 4-2, final 5 minutes. Shot from the bottom of the circle, misses wide. Petrantonio bounces to the far side. Duncan, shot on net, and it's swallowed up. Shinkarik and Fields exchanging words. 4:27 to go is, well, we're going about 10, 15 seconds between whistles right now.
Again, traffic jam hockey, I like it. Do not allow Columbus to get into a rhythm. Don't allow them. Don't allow it to happen.
And Columbus is going to be the one that has to try to take it to Motor City. Motor City has played well through the first 55 minutes and change. Good enough for a two-goal lead. McDonald draws against Giuliano. To the far boards. Milam tried to chip it out. Pins his man to the boards, and Delaney can't get it past Brody Duncan. Shot deflected into the corner. McDonald throws the body around, gets up and out of the zone. They want it offsides, not getting it. McDonald in close, and it's knocked away. Shot in front, Moore didn't get a lot of it. Poking, prodding, Hunter sent it to the corner.
McDonald's hunting, man.
Miguel Diaz up the near side. Anderson slides it to Duncan. Flips it in deep. Nick Miguel Diaz picks up the puck. Turned it over. McDonald out in front, and he couldn't find the tape of Moore. That was a golden opportunity. Svintsov gets it back to neutral ice. Rockers control it. Chip it in deep once again. Complete the change.
Kirk. You think that point streak matters to McDonald? He's playing with with his hair on fire. He's hunting, man.
I think
really
he's
is.
Trying to,
he's hunting.
To get one of those two back to give his team a shot to keep that 7-game winning streak intact. It is in critical condition right now. Into the offensive zone. Hunter pinned to the boards in the corner. Campbell slides it to the far side. Brody Duncan battles with Wells. Pinned on the boards. 3:05 to go and counting here in the third period. Back to Campbell, near side. Turned it over. Columbus has it. Slides to the left wing circle all the way to the boards. Wells battles again with Duncan. Out in front, right side. Swing and a miss from Bersani. Oh, boy, that was a golden opportunity.
It was a great opportunity for Bersani. Just couldn't get a stick on it. Bounced over.
See how long Colgan stays in net. We're getting to about that time. He seems pretty comfortable between the pipes right now. Josh Colton to the near side. Devon Fields returns. Can't get it out of the zone. Fields kicks it to his stick. Conway. Didn't get all of it, but got it over the blue line. Under 2.5 to go, 4-2 Motor City. Trying to knock off Columbus. In a final meeting of the regular season. Storjahan gives back behind the net. Bersani to the far side. Picked up by Devon Fields. Lost it. Shot kicked aside to the corner by Trevor Babin. Colgan showing no signs of moving as he's staring over at that bench. River Dragons have been controlling play. Shot in front and Vanderweel picked up the rebound, sitting on a platter. No white sweater there to tap it home. Balkwell slides in deep. Vanderweel, the only one there, picks it up. The captain knocked off the puck. Sneath comes in to help. King near side. Again, not a lot of movement from Colgan.
If there was a time to do it, now would be the time.
They've been controlling play for the last 2-3 minutes. Slides over all three lines. And Brendan Colgan patiently waiting. They don't need just one. They need two.
Well, if you're not going to pull him in a puck battle, you're not going to pull him at all.
And he started to move to the bench, turned over. Delaney, 3-on-2. Left it for Giuliano, return pass off his skate. Back to Giuliano. Jemayev comes in the corner. Final 60 seconds of this one.
Colgan's out.
Colgan racing to the bench. Pass off the mark. 6-on-5 hockey. Pietrantonio, pass. Gets knocked up and out of play. 50 seconds to go in the third.
Again, if you're going to have a puck battle down in the corner, how does Colgan not get out about 40 seconds ago?
I'm with you. I like pulling them with about 2.5-3 minutes left, especially if you're down two.
But, I mean, the puck was tied up.
Columbus did a great job controlling play in the zone. There were ample opportunities. It wasn't as if it was in the neutral zone and it was a risky pull.
Right. So it was the forecheck that allowed you that opportunity, and you didn't take it. Like, that, again, maybe everyone's seeing ghosts tonight, including Jerome Bouchard, which is very odd for Boomer.
Timeout, Columbus. 50 seconds to go in the third, and their 7-game winning streak in danger. This Motor City is that close to putting the cherry on top what has been a heck of a performance here at home against the top team in the Fed.
Well, the last time Columbus was here, a 16-game winning streak died. I'd like a 7-game winning streak to die, and I'd like a 38-game point streak to die. But we still have 50.4 to make that happen, and you bet your sweet dollar Justin McDonald will be on the ice ready just to hunt for that point. And the thing is, again, he has 68 assists. He's hunting by getting crossing passes. Anytime he's been on the ice hunting for this point under the last 4 minutes, it's been passing. He's not looking to shoot. He's looking to help. And that's what I appreciate by Justin McDonald. He's not selfish. He wants to be a playmaker that gets his teammates involved. And when you have a guy like that who's that hungry with something on the line like an historic streak, you can have a special moment. I mean, it's really cool to see. It's just, again, will we see history get snapped?
Last time the River Dragons dropped a game by multiple goals, you have to go all the way back to December 23rd when they lost 6-3 at Carolina.
And that was the last time Colgan lost.
Off the draw. Rings at a far side. Conway tipped it with the stick, battling Storjahan. Miguel Diaz shovels it all the way down. Icing will be the call, but they get it down to 37 seconds left in the third. Up 2 goals. I think the Rockers are willing to make that trade-off.
I think that trade-off all day. Killing 13 seconds. Are you kidding me? Take that every day.
Still 6-on-5. Colgan not going back in the crease. McDonald on the draw. He stands across from T.J. Sneath. Draw to the right of Trevor Babin. Clean win,
wow.
But to nobody in particular. Lane King pokes at it. Can't get it out of the zone. 30 seconds to go in this one.
What a play by Schleheka to keep that one in. That's a heck of an effort.
Pinned on the boards. McDonald shot kicked aside by Trevor Babin. Still close. Battle for it. Out in front. Hunter whacked at it. It went up and out of play. 19 seconds left to go. A scramble, but a heck of a job by Trevor Babin, making himself big and keeping the River Dragons off the board.
Every Rocker's like, it's a bird, it's a play. No, the puck! It's the puck, it's over there. Man, but again, McDonald, he's hunting.
19 seconds left to go in the third. Rockers looking to snap a three-game losing skid against the River Dragons. Stay in the battle for second place at home ice. Off the draw, long clear. Icing the call once again. Slaheko is on his horse, trying to save as much time as possible. Down to 12 seconds. Fans here at Big Boy Arena on their feet.
I am surprised the last two faceoffs have been poorly won by Columbus. No one was there to receive the puck after a win the last two times. You can't afford to make that mistake a third time.
McDonald on the draw. They need about a miracle to net 2 and 13 seconds. Off the
Another
draw.
One.
Doesn't go to anyone in particular. Out of the zone. 8 seconds left. Slaheka pass to Hunter. It hits off the helmet of Sneath up and out of play. And with 3 seconds left, then there's not enough time for two goals. And the Rockers are going to celebrate Friday night with 3 points.
Well, I will say this. There's enough time for a rocket shot by McDonald, but he's going to be taking the draw, so his streak is over.
With 3.5 to go in the third, the draw, nothing but a formality, goes over to Storjahan, and down goes Columbus. After going down to the Chattahoochee Valley, the Rockers come home and knock off the first-place Columbus River Dragons 4-2 in the final meeting of these two squads in the regular season. A heck of a performance from your Motor City Rockers.
Took it to them all game long. We said, could you build off what you did on Sunday? And guess what? Motor City took 60 minutes to respond, but they said, yes, sir, we can respond, and we'll take one. It was a big, big win for multiple reasons. We talked about the streaks being snapped, but guess what? Danbury's likely going to win, but you just kept them at bay as well.
You keep yourself right in the thick of the race. And with the Rockers' win on Tuesday from 5 to 9, fans with the offer on their phones can get a draft beer upgrade, 20-ounce beer for the price of 16. This will be supported after every home game via FanSafe here at the bar in the arena. You can see Rocker social media and arena announcements as we get ready for the three stars of the game. Ben, I think there were a bunch of guys that played really solid tonight who came away with the top three stars.
Well, the third star of the night is a guy who played with a heck of an effort all game long. He had a goal as well. Danny Vanderweel, the captain, is your third star of the night. Second star of the night is a guy who got everything started, but he also had two assists to go with his game starting goal. Pavel Svensson is your second star of the night. Top star of the night, TJ Delaney. A goal and two assists as well, and that is your lasting impressions, three stars of the game.
And you can only give three stars, but man, you can go up and down the list. Avery Smith, a guy we called out a few times. I thought Devon Fields, especially in the third, played well. Jonathan Giuliano, a lame king against his former team. You could tell he was motivated. Of course, the man in net, Trevor Babin, getting a huge round of applause. A heck of a team effort, complimentary hockey. And right there, Ben, we saw tonight 60 minutes of championship-level hockey. We know these Rockers have it in them.
Well, when we beat Binghamton, the only win this year, right, against Binghamton, we said we figured out the formula. Well, what was that formula? Playing smart, being physical, taking the game to them. And that's what Columbus does. Columbus is aggressive. They take a game to you all the time. But you know what? It's no coincidence that you're able to beat Binghamton with that formula. You're able to beat Columbus with that formula tonight. You got to keep that formula in your last three games and into the playoffs because you know what? It works.
Absolutely, it does. All smiles here at Big Boy Arena. Get to enjoy this one for a bit, but not too long because the Binghamton Black Bears are coming in tomorrow night, and they're going to be an angry bunch after kind of getting it taken to them up in McMorrin.
Well, they've been a different team away from the Forest of Vision Veterans Memorial, but it's going to be a fun game no matter what. Black Bears play tough. Brant Shearwood does a good job as well coaching that team. It's going to be a fun one tomorrow.
You want to talk about it, getting some momentum going into the playoffs. You have a bye week next week. Get 6 points against the two division leaders. Man, you're feeling on top of the world heading into your off week and right before the postseason. Motor City will drop the puck tomorrow night against Binghamton, looking to get 6 points on the weekend. But that'll do it for us here at Big Boy Arena. For my partner, Ben Zalagi, I've been Brady Beaton. The Rockers knock off Columbus, just the fifth loss in regulation this season for the River Dragons by a final score of 4-2. Thank you so much for spending your Friday night with me. Hope you tune in tomorrow. Have a great night, everyone.